Plus I'm cooking up ambition on the kitchen stove. Pot start to bubble, see the suds, that good to go. Damn suave, but I can't get Rico. Bro, think he John Wayne. I bought them Yellowstones, love the way they hang, babe. The silicone, everybody fake now. You could crack the code, bust down everything. Set in rose gold, dread talking to you like I'm J. Cole. I could tell a good before I even know. Don't tell me that you model if you ain't been in Vogue. Gotta throw a party for my day ones. They ain't in the studio, but they'll lay some. Rest in peace to Drama King. We was straight stunned. Y'all don't like the way I talk. Say some. Gotta throw a party for my day ones. Pull up and you know it's us, the bass jumping. Y'all don't like the way I talk and say something.
My face.
From Jack Ryan Field, here on the campus of Bishop Hartley High School, tonight, the Central Catholic League brings you a great matchup, a great rivalry, as the Hawks of Bishop Hartley play host to the Stallions of St. Francis DeSales. I'm Bob McGilligan, alongside of Matt Barnes here tonight. And Matt, these two teams look forward to this game all season long. Doesn't matter what else is on the schedule. This is the one that they zero in the summertime, and they're going to play it tonight.
Yeah, when you only play so many league games, you look forward to these rivalries, the blue and red, the purple and white here at Jack Ryan Field. Should be a good one. Two teams that always have big aspirations when it comes to the playoffs, but first you want to win your league, and here's a good chance to take a big step toward that, beating one or the other on your home field, so this should be a good one.
Yeah, the funny thing is about this league, you have teams that are in different divisions when it comes to the state playoffs. So you've got a Hartley team that's in a Division IV playing in Division II DeSales here tonight. None of that stuff ever seems to matter when it comes to rivalry games, though.
Exactly. Isn't that great? That's what's wonderful. Yeah, because Waterston's Division III, and all three of these teams seem to be very, very evenly matched. Obviously, St. Charles in there as well. So, yeah, that's what makes this fun. You play these same guys in grade school for the last 6, 7, 8 years, and now you're on the varsity field. And that's what makes it wonderful is that you know these guys, you know the competition is going to be tight, you know the trash talking is going to be amped up a little bit, the intensity picks up all week long in practice, and then comes to a head on Friday with these two teams battling it out on the field.
Well, the Hartley Hawks coming off a big win for them last week. They weren't surprised to win the game. But I think they might have been surprised the way they won their game.
I think there was some anger coming back after that Waterston loss, as they wanted to prove, all right, we are a better team than what we showed against Waterston. And, boy, you go against a really good Villa Angela St. Joe team, and you put a spanking on them. I think they're really impressed with that. And good momentum heading into this DeSales game. And, you know, if you're DeSales, you're a team that coming off a pretty bad loss yourself to Dover, 38-7. So now I think they're the team that comes in wanting to prove that they're not as bad as that game showed.
Yeah, they are probably okay with playing this game this week because of what you just said. You want to get amped up anyway, and you have no problem being amped up for this game.
100%. Doesn't take much to talk to the team about we've got to get better because we don't want to get embarrassed on the road at one of your rival schools. So, yeah, this is the perfect kind of get-right game for DeSales. You don't have to worry about getting the energy going. They'll bring it for this one right from the kickoff.
Ryan Perry, huge game last week. He wound up in the end zone three different times for the Hartley Hawks, and catching a couple of passes like this one right here.
Yeah, it's easy to catch when you're that wide open, but getting that open is not a problem for Ryan Perry either. He's just so fast and get by the defender. If they're not ready for that first two steps off the line, he will get by you, and he's done a really good job of making those catches right over the shoulder. Nice job of Matt Gallitz getting him the ball, too. He's become more confident as a quarterback as the year has gone on.
That's right, a sophomore quarterback, and you see they give him a little bit more opportunity. Last week, he got the opportunity. He made the most of it. This week, he's going to have to do it again. And I'll tell you right now, it's the Bishop Hartley Hawks that are going to kick it off to DeSales and give them the first opportunity to go on offense here tonight.
Perfect night out here, too. I mean, I was wondering with that rain how cool it was going to be. Instead, just a nice, comfortable temperature. Should be a nice, fun night of football.
And here's the ball in the air, and DeSales ready to take it. And Elazar Hood gets taken down at the 25, make it the 26-yard line. And that's where the Stallions are going to start. First down and 10. So good kick coverage there by the Hartley Hawks.
And this is our first chance to see that DeSales offense that is led by, yes, a freshman quarterback. You just don't see that very often in high school football, but especially at a program the level of DeSales. But he's got a famous name, and he's got a pretty good dad who knows how to coach some quarterbacks, and Ryan Day, RJ Day, is their quarterback, and didn't start week one, but came in week one and hasn't let go of it since.
Well, he immediately sets up in the shotgun. Man in motion, they'll pitch it to him. Coming toward the near side, there's a little bit of a hole. And up to the 32-yard line goes Bryce Herrick. He's a junior. He's a small running back at just 5'8", but you see he found the seam there, and he got up the yard for positive yard, up the field for positive yard.
And you'll see DeSales again. They're going to like to spread the ball out. They're going to want to get the ball out quickly. They have a lot of different weapons that they'll either on the quick pass, obviously running backs that they'll use as well. A lot of different options, though. The Hartley defense definitely had the game plan this week about who to defend.
Another handoff, and again, bouncing up the middle and stretching toward the first down marker this time is Jonathan Brown, and he's going to be close. As a matter of fact, they're going to give him the first down, so the chains will move.
And the Hartley defense was so good last week, not giving up many points at all to Villa Angel St. Joe. Again, nice response to them after giving up a ton of points against Waterston. Let's see what they have in store for the DeSales this week. Kind of that bend, don't break, or do they kind of really shut them down on this first drive? So far, giving up the first down.
That defensive line will be very important there for the Hartley Hawks, trying to slow down this running attack by DeSales. First down and 10. Day, again in the shotgun. Fakes the handoff, rolling to his left, wants to throw. Looking downfield, changing direction, and he's going to throw it out of bounds. That was the smart play. He was getting some pressure there right at the end, so he just tossed it out of play.
Yeah, he rolled to the left there, and Denham Cook was just kind of shadowing him. Wasn't really going after him per se. Didn't want him to get around him and get some yards rushing the ball. So instead, making him throw the ball, he looked downfield about 3, 4, 5 seconds. Nobody open. Great job by the secondary to make sure no one could get open with that much time. And smartly throws it away, play for another down.
So it'll be second down and 10. So they put the ball in the air for the first time tonight. Do the Stallions. They have two receivers to the bottom of your screen. One of those goes in motion. They're going to hand it off, though, and going off the right side, not getting much, is Jonathan Brown. Good job by the defense to get up there and just make the tackle.
Yeah, absolutely. Roy Ralston on that tackle there. And already you got DeSales in that third and long situation. You like to keep them in. This way you know they're probably going to have to throw the ball. Yes, they have receivers on the edge that they feel comfortable throwing it too, but if they can't get open, you can get some pressure on Day in the backfield. Force the freshman to throw the ball a little bit faster than he wants to. It's exactly what Hartley would love each time when you get to third down.
So he picked up two. Third down and 8. Once again, the four receivers set. Day wanting to throw. Looks near sideline. He's pressured, and he is brought down inside the 25 at the 24-yard line. And the man just bearing down is big Donovan Davis.
Yeah, I mean, he's a big man, but he's got quick feet, and he was, as you said, bearing down on RJ Day. RJ Day's not a really big guy. He's all 6 foot. And Donovan, yeah, I mean, when you've got 6'1", 275 running at you, I'd get down quickly too. So nicely done by that defensive line. We talked about how important that would be, getting pressure on Day. Did it right there on a third and long and forced the punt.
Brendan Ballard will be the punter, ready to receive the ball at about his own 15-yard line. Gets this kick away, end over end. Bouncing inside the 40-yard line. Takes a big Stallions bounce and rolls all the way down inside the 15 to the 12-yard line. Well, they got a nice kick. When that ball hit at the 40-yard line, it just took off.
Yeah, I mean, that's one where you tell, you know, a guy like Ryan Perry to get away from it, but at the same time, you see it rolling. You're like, man, just pick it up. Just save yourself 10 yards or... because now you're leaving yourself a long, long yard, long field, I should say, to go score after a really nice defensive stop. But, hey, got the ball after a nice defensive stop. Chance to put some points up.
So coming out to take over, the Hartley offense for the first time tonight. Matt Gulich pitches the ball back, and the Hawks trying to run it around the right side with limited success there. It looked like they just got over the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, not much there. Let's see again what kind of offense the Hawks pull out here today against this DeSales defense that has been prone to give up points. Again, 38 points to Dover last week. You know, the man that they're looking to give the ball to a lot is Robert Lathan Jr. Boy, what a season he's had. 870 yards, 13 touchdowns. Just been a fine player. And again, this is all from a sophomore I mean, that is what got excite all the Hartley fans, knowing that he's only going to get better with age.
Hand the ball off again, trying to go up the middle. And again, limited success. That the sales defense right there. And able to make the tackle as Roy Ralston carried the football that time.
Yeah, so far not much up the middle for the Hawks. This is where they like to really get going on their rush offense. But DeSales doing a nice job not falling for any of the motion or anything like that. Playing all those gaps, stuffing it. So now third and long. This is where, again, Matt Gulich, as the year has gone on, has gotten more comfortable throwing the ball. Ryan Perry is your go-to guy. See if he can get behind this defense. They're playing everyone within 5-6 yards of the box right now.
Gulich up under center. Takes the ball. Hands it off on the jet sweep. Trying to turn the corner and going to get knocked out of bounds. And that was Perry on the carry that time.
That was kind of doing a jet sweep around the corner, trying to see if he can get the first down. Looks like he's going to be a yard short. Does Brad Birch would dare go for it on fourth and one in his, inside his own 25? Doesn't look like he will. Well, never mind. Let's see. It is Perry. Here's the thing. Perry is the punter. And when you only need a yard or two here on fourth down, if I'm DeSales, I'm not necessarily playing for the punt here.
So let's see if the Hawks pull a trick play out early on here. Nope, they're going to kick it away. This is a good punt. That's going to send Davis Anderson back to the 42, and he's up over the 45 and then brought down at the 46-yard line.
Yeah, very nice punt by Perry there. You could see DeSales is definitely playing for him to run that ball. Weren't really rushing him, instead waiting for him to just kick it, which he did. So nice job by DeSales there, not allowing Hartley to get any of their rush offense going, force that three and out. And now they get the ball in a very favorable position right near midfield.
Yes, they do. And remember, DeSales, they got a first down on that first series, but then they went three and out right after that. So they went to running the football. The couple of passes that they've attempted, they haven't been able to complete. Three receivers all out to the right. And a handoff. And they try to go up the middle and then bounce to the outside. Good job by Avery Garlock there. He picks up positive yardage. Looked like he got hit at the line and might not go anywhere, but he picks up about four.
Yeah, really nice job. That's that. That's yards after contact. I mean, there's nothing there. He stuffed that line, like he said, bounces it outside, and nice job before getting taken down after a good gain. He's their number one running back. He's the one that they want to get going with their rush attack. If they get him going, that'll open up, hopefully, some of the pass game for RJ Day, something that they could not really get going in the first drive.
Second down and six. Man in motion. Day fakes the handoff, and he'll run it on the left side, and he's got the first down as he crosses the 45-yard line and winds up at the Hartley 42.
Yeah, and that's the part of, I think, RJ Day's game that Hartley's going to have to be prepared for. That kind of read option and then let him go. He's pretty quick, so you want to make sure you don't want to give him too much space. That defensive line can obviously pressure him on those passes, but then also make sure you maintain your lane so that way you don't let him scamper for 3, 4, 5 yards.
Day looking to throw, and he passes to the left side, and he's got his man right near the first down marker, Jack Elgin, with the reception, and he's got the first down.
Yeah, nice little up and out for Elgin there. And again, Ryan, RJ Day, I'm going to call him Ryan, it's going to drive me nuts, but he's Ryan Jr. Getting rid of the ball quick, so sees his man, throws him open, and perfect pass right at the sticks. Nice drive going so far for DeSales.
Hard count there as Day was trying to draw the defense offside. So we'll set it up again. And here's the handoff. And up the field, and Avery Garlock has himself a first down as he barrels all the way to the 20-yard line.
And there you go, right then. That's the guy they want to get going. And after a nice completion, that's exactly what DeSales wants, is to be able to then open up their rush game. And nice, easy pass there. And already Brad Birchfield calling timeout, seeing something he doesn't like on that defense. And as they hit the red zone, not wanting them to give up any more yards and give up that first score if possible.
So the Hawks just trying to regroup and see if they can get things back together. Yeah, Well, the Yamo Media app is now available at the App Store, the Google Play Store, and available on the new and improved YamoMedia.com. On the app, you can watch all of the live-streamed events that Yamo Sports produces, as well as studio shows produced locally here in Columbus. Shows like Sean Anthony Live, Hey Bucks, David Carter's The Catalyst, The Rick and Reese Show, The Wiseman Say, and Yamo's upcoming hockey show, Rinkside Columbus, will all be available on the Yamo Media app. Yamo Media, achieve more. Be a first down and 10 for DeSales. Day looking to throw again. Looks to his right, puts it in the air, and this is picked off in the end zone. He overthrew the intended receiver, and the Hawks there to make the catch.
Xavier Martin Fuller, nicely done. And, I mean, this one, I don't know if this was the receiver in the wrong spot or just an overthrow by Day, but Martin Fuller looks like the guy who's catching the touchdown. Instead, it's for a touchback and the interception. Nicely done. He's trying to get that ball to Michael Walker. But, yeah, like I said, it's either an overthrow by Day or the receiver's running the wrong route because, yeah, it looked like the receiver's doing a slant and he thinks it's going to be a go.
Yeah. Yeah, watching that replay, it's that's the indication right there, mm-hmm. right? He cuts to his left at the goal line, and the ball sails behind him.
Yep.
So Gulich has the offense back out there for the Hawks, and they get DeSales to jump. I think they got them to jump. There was a lot of movement there. I believe this is on the defense.
Yeah, I mean, the quarterback's allowed to come out of the center and change the play, and that's what happened. It looked like the defense jumped. So it should be an offside.
Well, it takes three guys to talk about it and report to the fourth guy. And it will indeed be against the offense, or against the defense, sorry. The offense got him to jump. Encroachment on the defense. Well, for an offense that went three and out in their yep. first possession, it's a nice start. They've done nothing, and they've gotten 5 yards.
This will surely help, and now you can open up the whole playbook here, including a first down pass.
Robert Latham, the tailback, in the offset eye formation. They don't hand it to him. Gulich throws on the run, and he's got his man at the 40-yard line, and that is Perry. Actually, they'll say his knee was down at the 39-yard line, but a nice catch by Ryan Perry.
Yeah, nice 14-yard gain there, and really, really nice pass there. That's tough. Again, you're running to your left, trying to make that throw on the run, and Perry doing a real nice job, make sure he gets to the ground, just gets that ball secured. Even if you're on the ground, it doesn't matter. It's first down yardage.
Nice sidearm throw on the run. You could tell Gulich played shortstop right there. And that right. throw that he made, that's what that was. But now it's the Hawks to jump offside. There's a false start, and that'll back them up 5 yards.
Yeah, as soon as you get those 5 yards, give it right back, and this is going to make it tough. You don't want those first and 15s, that's for sure. You want to stay in front of the sticks and keep it to those manageable yardage. But, again, playbook's wide open here. You saw that, you know, Gulich feel comfortable throwing the ball. Obviously, with a great target in Ryan Perry, but still got to feel comfortable trying to get that run game going. They know they're going to have to win this game running the ball for sure.
Latham yet to really be a part of it. And I know it's only been a couple of offensive plays for the Hawks, but they're looking to get him involved. Instead, they're going to hand it to the first man through. And, again, getting through is not getting much right there. There was no running room.
Yeah, it's Bryson Winbush trying to get a little tricky here in terms of not giving it to the first man, giving it to the second man. And, boy, just nothing doing, nothing at all. DeSales eating it up inside the tackle so far. See if Hartley can do anything outside of the tackle. They were able to get about 6-7 yards of that jet sweep on the first drive. But so far, if they're running inside the tackles, it's been maybe 3 yards total.
Well, the Hawks this year have gone a lot with that double handoff.
Yeah.
So very similar right there. It's only one handoff, but that's exactly where the guy's going to go, right up the middle. So they stayed at home.
Yeah, different concept, but I'm sure DeSales has scouted that all week long.
Gulich looking to throw, and he passes on the right side. This is caught, but again, this is going to be for little yardage.
Boy, and now you're really giving yourself, you're really shortening the playbook here. We have third and 14. This is just great pursuit again by the DeSales. I mean, look at this. He catches the ball at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, all those DeSales Stallions defense is on the receiver right there. Nothing wrong with trying to get that ball outside. We just talked about it. It's getting tough inside the tackle, but that play did not work at all. Great job by the DeSales D.
So third down and 14. And the Hawks, who love to run the football, this isn't a running situation for them. The ball It's fumbled right off the snap, and there's DeSales to pick it up.
Boy, and that has an issue. That has been an issue for this team for some reason in the last few weeks. The center to quarterback exchange. This one never gets the Gulledge. Ends up on the ground. DeSales jumps right on it. And it's Johnny on the spot there. And that is a tough turnover. Yes, you're probably maybe not going to get that first down, but to give them the ball inside their plus 40, absolutely brutal. I was at the Watterson game, and, you know, Hartley had that happen about 6-7 times, a couple of times for a turnover. I know it's something they've probably still been working on, but they've got to get that figured out because these turnovers are absolutely terrible when you're giving them a short field.
Max Shula was the guy that came up with the football for DeSales. So each team has turned the ball over, and here's a little pitch to the man in motion. And taking the football was Michael Walker up over the, or inside, the 35 to the 34.
Yeah, a little pop pass to Walker. That's the second time they've tried to do that. Not a ton of yardage, but it is positive yardage as DeSales got to take advantage of this opportunity. Short field. But we saw the last time Hartley got, or DeSales got into the red zone, the Hartley defense stepped up big and got that turnover. So chance for them to really show off what they have and keep this a scoreless game.
Day hands it off, and they go right up the middle. Boy, look at that stack as they just get Jonathan Brown and push him backwards.
Yeah, I mean, that was Donovan Davis was there, Roy Ralston, Jay Zhang. Looked like everyone was just pushing him back right when he got to the line. Just absolutely nowhere to go. Great job by the defensive tackle. Then the linebackers joining in. So defense doing their job so far. Got him to third and long. Forced the sales to make a big play here. See if the freshman can come through.
Empty set here with five receivers. Day with a hard snap count. Couldn't draw the defense.
Yeah, you'd love to get some pressure on him here, but at the same time, make sure he doesn't have a quarterback draw. Don't give him a lane.
Well, he had some time, and now that time is gone. And R.J. Day brought down back at the 39-yard line.
Yeah, that was a great job of the Hartley defense. Again, what I just mentioned there, you want to get some pressure on, but at the same time, not give him a lane to run in. And that was really well done. Look at that. Great job. Charlie McCall looks like he's owned on that tackle. And so and a few of his other friends as well. That's Jay Zhang as well, number 45 right there. Really nice job by that Hartley defense. You're given the task of trying to stop them inside their own 40-yard line. They pick up 1 yard on that drive in three plays.
Brendan Ballard on for his second punt of the evening. Ballard will kick it away from about the 47. He just does get it in the air. And this one will bounce. This time it takes a Hartley bounce, and it'll be down at about the, right around the 20-yard line, maybe the 18-yard line.
Well, so far, exactly what you might think. You have a rivalry game. Two teams that know each other pretty well. They don't need to scout each other as hard because they play each other each and every year. And 0-0 start, not a surprise at all. Let's see if either team can really break through. Hartley hasn't been able to cross their 50 yet, so we'll see if their offense can really get going.
Hawks back on offense, and they will try to run the football, and it's Lathan that gets it. He's taken down after a short game. But he can save the date for April the 13th. Hartley's Evening of Excellence will be taking place once again. Can't miss prizes, a wonderful catered meal, and much more. The Evening of Excellence will take place on April the 13th, so make sure you save the date.
I already have because they said I have to be there.
Second down and 8. Here's a pitch to the near side. And there's a little bit of running room, but not a lot still. Trying to find a way to stretch it out there with Winbush with the pitch that time. And right now this offense is just trying to find a way to run the football.
Absolutely, Matt. Yeah. I mean, the biggest play so far has been that 14-yard pass. But in terms of the rush game, that the Tide's maybe their best play, about a 5-yard gain there. You know, getting the ball outside has worked, but boy, those long pitches aren't plays you want to be doing each and every time. You'd love to be able to get it inside the tackle. But so far, you can see DeSales is playing, you know, 4 on the line and about 5 guys within 3 yards of the line of scrimmage. It's going to make it tough to run the ball. So maybe Gulch's going to have to throw the ball a little bit more than he's comfortable.
Well, he goes up under center in a 3rd down and 3. Winbush in motion. handed off and cutting up the middle is Lathan. He breaks free, and there he goes. He's at midfield, inside the 40, stiff arm and brought down at the 22-yard line.
Well, that's the thing. If you're DeSales, you're going to play that many guys close to the box. One lane, and if he gets by that second level, which, again, is only 3-4 yards in like Lathan did, he is going to go, and that's exactly what happened here. Watch him find this great lane. Right. Oh, great tackle or great blocking by Brandon Lorette there. And then away goes Lathan for a big game, but nicely done by Hartley. They've been working it, trying to get that run game going. They finally do, and it goes for a big, big game.
Hood was the only man that stopped a touchdown right there. We're going to get a procedure call here against Hartley. And they're going to be backed up 5 yards.
Boy, you hate to get those 5 yards, give 5 yards up there, but again, talk about momentum for the Hartley offense right there. That's exactly what, that's why you keep running the ball. Yes, it can be frustrating. We're only getting 1 yard, 2 yard, but Robert Lathan has had a great year for many reasons, and one of them is his patience. I thought he was a really patient runner on that play. Waited for that hole to open, and then he went for it after he saw that gap.
Going to hand it to him again. And he got caught and brought down. He was there. He was using that patience. He slowed down. He was looking for the hole to open, and then he had his leg grabbed hold of.
Yeah, it looked like Lincoln Chulov. DeSales grabbed his ankle and wouldn't let him go. But, yeah, it was a nice job there. He saw the lane, and then he went for it. But, again, great job by the linebacker. And, yeah, tight first quarter, as expected, when you have these two teams face the field. They only scored 9 points in the game last year, so
that's
why
right.
Not?
That's right. That is the end of the first quarter here. As each team has turned it over once, neither team has put it in the end zone. Heck, they haven't even been able to kick a field goal. 0-0 with one quarter in the books here at Bishop Hartley as they take on the Stallions of DeSales. You're watching Hartley Football on Yamo Media.
Today's highlights are being presented by The Mortgage Captain. Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331 to start your home buying journey. By Yamo Sports and Yamo Media. The new app is available next week. Find it on the App Store and Play Store. By Training ABC. Create training courses for your organization. Visit trainingabc.com. Page Tech Lemonade. Virtual, live events, multimedia. And by Jenny Osmond, proud Hartley alumni from the class of 2000 and your realtor from Core Realty Collection.
Bishop Hartley with the football, looking at the second down and 13. We've got two big plays in this game. One was a passing play for 14 yards. The other was the big run Robert Lathan Jr. just turned in a few minutes ago.
And it looks like Ryan Perry have to come off with some kind of uniform issue. So if the play call was a pass play to him, not going to go to him anymore. It's going to go to Fidel Tejoma, who goes out, who goes in for him.
You need 13 yards. That's the guy you want on the field.
It does.
But they don't have him right now. Galich up under center. Fakes a handoff to the back. They've got the man coming around in motion. And guess who wasn't fooled? And that was the defense of St. Francis DeSales, and it was Max Shulaw pursuing and tackling.
Yeah, really nice play by him. They got that ball to Bryson Wimbush. He's got some speed if he can get to the outside, but, I mean, there's just nowhere to go. Really nice job, and if Shulaw doesn't get him there, Faulkner's going to get him. So, yeah, just really, really good defending by DeSales, making sure they stay in those, stay in their assignments to not let them get to the outside.
Now you're looking at the third down and 17.
And you'd love to see them throw the ball deep here, see if Ryan Perry can get under one.
Galich dropping back, and he will go long. He's got a man in the end zone, and it's a touchdown.
And who else? Ryan Perry, as expected. That is their one, that is the man they want. I'm a little surprised the Seals didn't have a safety over top of that. You have to think if they're going to throw the ball deep on third and 17, it was going to be to Ryan Perry, and look at this. I mean, he just gets by his defender easily. Gull's doing a nice job. Just throw it up. Let your man go get it, and he does. Perfect pass, perfect catch. Really, really well done. Touchdown, Hawks.
Oh, look at the way he just drops this in here.
Plenty of time, too. Great job by the line. Listen, those two have become a great connection as the year's gone on.
Hartley attempting the extra point, and it is blocked. So they don't get the seventh point. They'll have to settle for six.
That's a rare mistake from the special teams unit. They've been pretty good on extra points this year. That one with a low line drive right in the back of the center, though. So have to settle for six.
Well, that's the bad news. They have to settle. The good news is they got the six, and they did it on a third down and 17.
Yeah.
Again, you're talking about an offense that loves to run the football. Mm-hmm. They got taken out of their element there, and they found something that worked.
That's what I thought. Yeah, exactly. And just two big plays in that drive. What they come on? Third down, right? Third and short, they got the big run play. Third and 17, one where you think they're in trouble. Now they just go over the top and score that way. So now you have DeSales thinking what they need to stop, both the pass and the run. If you're Hartley, just feel good because your defense is playing well, and now your offense finally gets going. It's a good way to start the second quarter, get some momentum, and kind of take some of the sting out of this DeSales defense that had come out really flying around.
Well, and as you just said, if you are defending a one-dimensional offense, way easier,
yeah.
Right? And that's what they were forcing them into. All of a sudden, whoa, two dimensions here.
Yeah.
Now there are adjustments that are going to have to be made. And it could be one of those nights for the Hawks that you got to use the pass to set up the run. Normally,
yep.
they do the opposite.
Absolutely. I was thinking the same thing. They've been able to pass the ball pretty good. So maybe that will open up some lanes for Lathan.
Boy, and DeSales having to smother the football.
That ball stayed in bounds for a long time.
The way that ball was angled toward the sideline, I thought, well, this doesn't look good. It might just go out.
Yeah.
And, they love to do that. There's no doubt about it. But it looked like it was going to angle out of bounds.
Yeah.
Then they get the bounce. And now, if you're the receiving team,
you gotta
that's
jump
a live
on
ball.
Absolutely. And that's the thing. And there were the Hartley player rolling down there. Here's the thing. If you know your kicker can't get it throughout to the end zone and give him at the 25, it is your next best option right here, right? That angled kick where it stops at the 23-yard line right here. Well done by the special teams unit. Kind of make it up for that extra point with a kickoff like that.
Well, let's see if DeSales can answer now. Down 6-0. RJ Day taking that snap and hands it off. And coming up the middle is Garlock. Not a lot there as the Hawks quickly close down on him.
Yeah, really nice job. Again, that Hartley defensive line. There's not much there for Garlock there. That's McCall again. There's Jay Zhang bottling it up and grabbing that tackle. So, again, that's what DeSales wants to do. They want to do the same thing. They want to have the run open up the pass. And Garlock has their guy to do that. But if they're only going to get 2-3 yards out of pop, at least a third and long, and then it's all on Day after that.
Hand it off again. Hawks get there quickly and take him down at the 26-yard line.
Boy, I thought for a second Xavier Martin Fuller had him for about a 2-yard loss. Just slipped by him, but still, not a big carry. You're going to leave third and medium, third and long here for Day. And we've noticed on those plays, he's waiting for his receivers to get open, but there's no one open. And then it's on him to either run it or elude the tacklers. And so far, the Hartley defenders have been winning that battle. He's been sacked a couple times. So let's see what happens this time. It looks like he's going to go into center this time.
Fakes the handoff. Day sets up. He's got some time. The time is now running out, and he's got to run the football himself. To the far side of the field, he's brought down. And we've got a flag coming here. You had to figure that was going to happen as he got hit high around the neck at the 30-yard line.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if he got his face mask or he just got underneath that neck collar there. Have to wait for the replay to really see. Either way, it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Yeah, it looks like they're saying face mask. Let's get a replay of that. First off, really nice job by Day eluding the tackle. It seemed like he was dead to rights. Denham Cook just missed him. And then after that, it looks like he has a nice lane to get it all. And then, yeah, boy, it looks like he went around his neck. And again, I'm not sure the high school rule compared to the NFL rules. If that was the NFL, I think that might have been fine. But in high school, I think they're going to protect the quarterback in high school a little bit more. So it got him around the neck, brought him down that way. Throw the flag for a personal foul. But nice shot by Day. He's the one who made that play.
Yes, he did. And with the 15 yards, he gets tacked on. They're up to the 45-yard line. Big play because that drive was dead, and now it's alive. Here's Day again, bouncing to the outside. This time he'll just go out of bounds.
Yeah, better job by Hartley there. Again, he's going to do that a lot. He's going to like to scramble. You just don't want him to get too many yards. 3-4 yards, that's fine. That's no big deal. But don't let them get those 8 to 10 yard chunks. That's for sure. So just stay in your lane. If you're supposed to set the edge, keep that edge. Don't let him get too far. But so far, so good by Hartley. See, like right there, Denham Cook kept that edge, so it forced him to go inside the tackle, and that allows the rest of his teammates to do the rest of the work and get him out of bounds as soon as possible.
Second down play after the gain of four. And here's the handoff. Garlock around the right side, and he got that second burst toward the first down marker. They're going to put him, I believe, a little short.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to be a yard short, but... So now you're seeing DeSales. They're kind of bypassing going up the middle instead, trying to go to the outside. Nice blocking by them. A lot of guys in front of them, led there by Jacob Priest, big 6'4" lineman from DeSales, blocking the way. So good drive so far, kind of imposing their will here to DeSales. They try to get their run game going. Again, maybe open up the pass, because so far the passing offense has not been successful.
Dave just going to take it himself, and he launched forward, and he has it. By a mile. He got about 3 yards there.
Yeah, for seemed like a quick quarterback sneak. So, again, that's all DeSales trying to do. Ball control, move the ball. And, again, using the run game to do that right now. I think both teams would agree they want this to be a physical game. And you're seeing DeSales not spreading the ball nearly as much. They decide to put up a whole bunch of guys on the line now.
Another handoff, and they try the right side. Try again. There was nowhere whatsoever for Walker to go.
Yeah, and that was yet again Donovan Davis, the big man in the middle, not allowing anything to happen there. They kind of went quick there, too, and it didn't matter. Davis was ready. No, yeah, good luck trying to get by him. It's also Denham Cook there on the tackle, too. So, yeah, nice job by Hartley. Sales tries to go quick, and the Hawks were prepared. At least that D-line was.
No gain on that play. Again, Day uses that hard count.
Got to be disciplined as they do that. Don't jump offside to give them a free five.
Take the handoff. Now Day goes up the middle, and he's going to get close to the 35-yard line. That'll leave him about 3 yards shy of the first down marker.
Yeah, that was Bryce Herrick going in motion, and Ryan Day, oh, there it is again. I knew I was going to do it. RJ Day decides to keep it himself, and nice job. See the lane there. Gets a solid gain. Leaves himself third and three.
Malik Tufts finished off that tackle for the Hawks. You have to wonder if this is four down territory for DeSales. The way they're running the football right now, 2 or 3 yards at a time, and they only need to get, let's call it a long three. They only have to get almost 4 yards here.
Yeah.
Garlock, he cannot find a way to turn the corner. That's a great play on third down by the Hawks, and now the decision has to be made by DeSales what they want to do.
Yeah, because now we're talking like fourth and six, but boy, this is where, again, when you decide to go lateral when you only need about 4 yards, it can always be a little dicey, and boy, the Hawks defense all over that one. It looks like Denham Cook was in on that tackle, a few others as well, and yeah, now you're forcing DeSales to make that decision, and looks like they are going to punt. I'm a little surprised by this, frankly, just because the last punt only had about a net of about 15 yards when they did this. I thought they might go for it, and if they leave Hartley here, so be it. Trust your defense.
Ballard, high snap. He brings it down, and he will kick it away. And a fair catch is called for and taken at the 9-yard line.
Ooh, that was dicey. But nice job getting that ball, and then a really nice kick. Left him inside the 10-yard line. So it's going to be a long field for the Hawks, but that could have gone horribly wrong if that ball gets by the punter in any way.
I got to be honest with you. I thought he might run.
I did too for a second.
The yardage.
Yeah, and I think he thought about it, but he started to roll to the right before he kicked. I think the thing that stopped him was knowing how many yards he had to get. He was still about 10 yards behind the line, and still had to get another six.
It was a nice catch by Joey Wooten, by the way, on that fair catch. Not an easy one. He had to go down to his knees to make the catch. And here come the Hawks. They take the man out of the backfield here. Does this mean they're going to pass the football? Who knows? They're going to bring a man in motion. And they will hand it off. And the sales, as they have done all night, they have just closed the middle of the field down.
Yeah, starts. Some of these runs look like a rugby scrum after a while because there's nowhere to go. And the whole team just flies to the football. Again, hasn't been a ton of room to run inside the tackles. Besides that one long one from Lathan, it has been tough sledding for all the Hartley running backs. Doesn't matter who it is.
And you see Roy Ralston there. That was Zhang that time carrying it. He got hit initially, had another opportunity, but found there was still nothing there.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, again, credit to DeSales. They are just absolutely tackle machines so far. They've done a great job keeping Hartley in contained there.
Well, second down, lost about a half yard on the play. And they're going to try to go with that jet sweep again, and they only get up over the 10-yard line, and there's nothing doing.
Yeah, nothing doing at all. And, yeah, I can understand why DeSales is fired up with the way their defense is playing. This is a great job, again, stringing this out, and then right when he tries to take it upfield, there's just nowhere for Ryan Perry to go. I mean, absolutely wonderful job. That's number six, Cameron Gwynn, the BC commit. He's a good player, obviously, and one that really makes this defense go. And nice job there with the strong tackle. Third and long again for the Hawks. Got to think they want to pass it here, and Ryan Perry's your go-to guy.
Well, I think they'll give him a little bit more attention than they did on the touchdown that he caught. Winbush goes in motion. Fake the handoff. Gullich rolling, and he throws on the run, and it's picked off and headed toward the end zone for the touchdown. Elijah Charles.
Yeah, that one just wasn't there. Kind of tried to force that one in there. And Elijah Charles read that one immediately for the pick six. And you were right. This one wasn't to Ryan Perry. Ryan Perry was the deep man, and Perry had two men on him. So he tried to go to the shorter man right around the sticks. But, again, he is covered, and Elijah Charles jumps the route, and away he goes. That pass was a little bit to the inside shoulder. He wanted it to be toward the sideline instead. Maybe he can't then jump that route and get the touchdown. But regardless, a really nice play by Charles. And the DeSales defense responds right when they needed to after their offense kind of got bogged down inside the 40.
Oh, and again, another extra point that doesn't happen here. That ball is still rolling around, but they have whistled the play dead.
Yeah, it's a dead ball in high school. In college and pros, you can pick that up and go back for two, but can't do that in high school. But that's big. I mean, it could be 7-6, and then you never know with this game if we're going to have another score. But, oh, boy, that snap was well over the holder's head. Brendan Ballard didn't have a chance to get that one.
Well, they almost snapped it over Ballard's head when he was punting.
That's right, yeah.
And now he's holding for the extra point. They do snap it over his head.
Like, hey, can you help me out here?
He said, all right, I'm not getting down. Yeah. If you're going to snap it, I'll stand up. No, I can't. Yeah, you're right. It's a big break for Hartley because it is a tie game now.
Yeah.
Tie game right now, so the Hawks ready to get the football back. Well, did you know that you can support Bishop Hartley and earn a tax credit on your Ohio income taxes for 2023? Visit EmmausRoadScholarship.org or scan the QR code to learn more about making a gift that turns your tax dollars into scholarships at Bishop Hartley today. So the Hawks give up the 6 points on the pick six. Still can't run the football the way that they want to run it. I'll tell you what, the sales, they obviously watch a lot of film on the games this year. You know how to play Hartley when you come in, but the personnel is always different. And when they throw five guys at you that can run the football at any point in time, they've stopped them all.
And so far, Hartley's done everything they've tried. So, you know, the jet sweep with Ryan Perry. They've given Winbush the ball on that kind of double handoff. Lathan just up the gut. Jay Zang, Roy Rawson have been shut down so far. So, yeah, they've given it to all five of their studs. And besides the one big Lathan run, it has been tough sledding for the Hartley offense.
We get a whistle.
Yeah, this one's offside on the DeSales on the kickoff. So moving back 5 yards. But, yeah, I mean, if you're DeSales, you've clearly, again, you've played this team each and every year. In 2020, you played them twice in the year. If you don't know the personnel, you at least know the offense. So you're prepared, this shows right here. A 7-2 game last year, that was an instant classic in a low-scoring game. So I'm not surprised at all to see this be a little tighter of a matchup, even though you have a team like the Sales that seems to be struggling all season. And then Hartley, who's flying off to a big win, doesn't matter. Again, rivalry games do that.
And I am interested to see how Hartley responds, reacts, whatever you want to say, because they're making you have to throw the ball.
Yeah.
Now your quarterback just threw a pick six. Are you going to go back to letting him throw the ball right now? Are you going to still try to get that running game going? How's it going to work?
Yeah, I agree. I was wondering, maybe on first down, do you try to get some confidence back in and say, let's throw the ball on first down? You know, let's see what happens. But I know deep down, Chris Sawyer and the team really want to get that run game going.
Harley picks it up and This is actually going to be a good run back for what they were dealing with as they get back to where are they going to spot this at the 27-yard line. Well, that ball was bouncing all around. It hit one of the up men.
Yeah, not bad at all, I think. I mean, even just getting 5-10 yards on that run back seemed like a success. That was, for a second, I thought he might break it for a little bit more than that.
Yeah, Winbush did all he could do there. Finally, too many white jerseys. So now we get, we've got holding against Hartley during the return, so that's going to back him up 10 more yards.
Yep, and that's not what you want. But you got 5 minutes here. This is the exact kind of drive that you like if you're Hartley, which is be able to hopefully use the rest of this clock, end this quarter, end this half with a score and take the lead heading into halftime. But that involves keeping this at second and manageable, third and short, finding a way to get some yards on first down, which they have really had struggled getting even 4 yards on first down because it's the DeSales defense that just swarmed the football.
Winbush in motion. And hand it off, and Lathan, there he goes, up the middle. He's got the first down to the 29-yard line.
Yeah, really nice job here by Lathan, but even more of a shout-out to the offensive line. He had a nice cutback lane to the right, and watch him just take this. I think he doesn't get touched until about 5-6 yards down the field. Yeah, look at that. Look at that. Those run lanes for him. That is wonderful before he gets taken down past the first down marker. So maybe that's a sign of what they've seen after the first, 19 minutes or so of game time, of what they need to do to get this run game going.
Going to give it to him again. And he got across the 30. His knee went down at about the 32.
But even then, and it just looked like he got tripped up. If he can break that tackle, that's going to be a big gain. You're starting to see some lanes for him to run through. Really nice blocking here. Yeah, just got tripped up. Actually, it looked like by his own guy, kind of tripped on his foot. But, yeah, you're starting to see some a little bit more confident running by Lathan. Again, DeSales is still playing 10 guys within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage, so it's going to be tough to run. But they're not. Hartley's not going to stop doing it just because of that.
Go with a quick handoff this time, and they'll get it up to about the 35.
So, again, not a big gain there as DeSales calls timeout. Again, Ryan Wiggins, their head coach, already thinking we can get a stop here and get the ball back with a lot of time left. But it's not a big game by Hartley, but now you leave yourself 3rd and 4, 35. That opens the whole playbook for you. You can still run the ball here. You can do a shorter pass. You don't have to throw it deep to Ryan Perry. You can do kind of a slant or, something across the middle here. So plenty of options.
No, we're talking about the Hawks, and the run game, tough to come by here tonight. And Lathan, if you look at it, they haven't used him as much as they've used some of the other guys.
I agree, yeah, yeah. We've seen a lot more jet sweeps without him, things like that. We've seen Winbush and Perry get the ball. In other words, he should be fresh.
Yeah, and I wonder if that was by design at all.
I do too, yeah.
And you try to get those other guys going. They're not going.
Yeah.
None of them are going. And then all of a sudden he comes in. There have been a couple of runs he was stopped after two or three, but he's got two big runs
in
this game.
Absolutely, yeah. And I think it's just a look that DeSales has given him. I mean, again, they've got 9-10 guys playing so close to the line and all about within the tackle box. I think it makes sense to try to do the jet sweeps. They're just doing a really good job defending those as well.
I got Lathan back there alongside the quarterback in the shotgun. And now they'll hand it to him. And up the middle he comes. And he just got tripped up. He's going to be short by a yard, maybe a little bit more than a yard.
Boy, I tell you what, I know this is a gutsy call, but this feels like a time when you want to go for it. You feel like you got your run game going. It is it's a healthy yard. Don't get me wrong. And, running in between the tackles has been really tough for Hartley. But, boy, this seems like a big moment in this game. If you can find a way to get a first down here, maybe hold the ball for the rest of the half. But if you don't, you give the DeSales offense a chance to score. And great field position.
Offset eye. Lathan, the deep man, they're going to pitch it to him, and he's got the first down. He's got more. Comes to the near sideline and inside the 40. The 30 is knocked out of bounds.
Well, we said it was a big play, and that is a big result. How about that? 4th and 1. You do that little pitch, give him all the momentum to run forward. You think all he's trying to do is get a yard, and instead he finds a way to get about 40. Boy, look at this right here. I mean, that's really well done. Nice job blocking by Ryan Perry, helping to get more yardage. Thought they were going to call for a late hit here at the end because he kind of dragged him down. But all in all, who cares? First down for the Hawks, and keep this drive going and keep DeSales offense off the field.
Now we get a whistle and a flag coming off the near sideline, and it's going to be another illegal procedure. So a false start by the offense, and again, that'll cost them five.
Yeah, Brad Birchfield not a fan of that call. I mean, I didn't see anyone moving, but that's a big call, though, because, again, you don't want to give up those 5 yards. When you have that offense rolling, first 15, just so much harder to get those 15 yards compared to 10 yards in three plays, especially with the way the DeSales defense is playing so far this game.
Lathan not in there right now, and they're going to turn. Well, he is in there. He wasn't behind the quarterback. He was off on the wing. They hand it to him, and he gets taken down.
Yeah, yet again, just DeSales has done a really nice job scouting that kind of delayed handoff that goes to the kind of the up man, if you want to say that. They've done a really nice job containing that play. I've seen a lot of Hartley games this year where the teams have really struggled figuring out that, yeah, he didn't give it to the first guy, but he's giving it to the next guy. And they've let that lane open up. They are not allowing that to happen on this night so far. Those have been only 1 or 2 yard gains at the most.
After a gain of one, it's second down and 14.
And a rare look by Hartley going four wide. You don't see that very often. Let's see if this is actually a pass, though.
Well, we get another flag.
Yeah, looks like we got a timeout from Hartley first.
Yeah, it was just about to be delay of game.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and I think Brad Virchow saw that from the sideline, could not afford to give up another 5 yards.
No, he could not give up that 5 yards, so timeout with 2:27 to go here in the first half of a 6-6 game. Well, Bishop Hartley would like to welcome the 1983 football team, the CCL champion Hawks. At halftime, there'll be a special presentation on the field. And we'll bring that to you. You're watching Bishop Hartley football presented by Yamo Sports. The Hawks trying to get some points here before the end of the half. Deadlocked at 6 with St. Francis DeSales.
Yeah, what a game this has been so far. Defensive battle. The only scores that DeSales gotten has been on that pick 6. But Hartley, again, you're starting to see signs that the run game is starting to work. But at the same time, it's taking those huge chunk plays. They're still not getting 4 yards at a time, 5 yards at a time. And that just makes it tough on these now second and longs. Again, Matt Golich has that one great throw to Ryan Perry, another one, a 14-yard game. But beyond that, it's been tough for him to get going as well. So let's Perry. See. I'd like to see him throw the ball here.
Yeah, Perry right now is at the top of your screen. Lathan's in the slot. And, well, the defense almost came across there. Matthias Pearl is able to stay on his side of the football. Golich will bring Perry in motion, hand the ball to him. Ryan trying to turn and can't do it.
Absolutely nothing there. Yeah, and that's a really, really nice shot by Elijah Charles on the edge there. Wasn't blocked, just made sure he made a sure tackle on Perry, because if not, Perry may have gotten around the corner. But, again, DeSales doing what they need to do, making sure Hartley can't get around the edge. And, well, we've been here before, right? Third and long around this distance. We saw what happened. Again, wouldn't be surprised to see a safety over top, possibly. As of right now, though, Perry's at the top of the screen, and he's all alone, one-on-one coverage with the larger hood. We'll see if they change that. Got Davis Anderson in the back at the safety, but I don't know if he's going to go with Perry or not.
Golich brings Winbush in motion. Hands it off. Winbush trying to turn that corner on the far side of the field. He does, but not for much. He's inside the 30, but he'll only get to the 27.
See, and now if you're Hartley, you're kind of in no man's land here, right? You know, you don't have a field goal kicker that can, you know, get you a 45-yard field goal. You also have 4th and 7, and you probably don't mind with a minute 30 left giving DeSales the ball here. So, yeah, it's all go here. The question is, again, are you throwing the ball or are you trusting your run game to possibly get you those 7 yards?
Well, this time Perry's at the bottom of the screen. Well, there he is right in the middle of your screen, but he's down at the wide side of the field.
And, again, that's single coverage. There's no safety. I'm looking to throw him the ball right at the S and the Hawks in the end zone.
Golich rolling out to his right. Looks for Perry. Throws on the run, and the catch is made. The tackle is broken, and the ball is down to the 15-yard line. That's a first down.
Yeah, I was thinking the go route. Hartley thinking something even better, which is go and stop, and came back right at the sticks for the first down. And what a throw. Gullich with an absolute fastball there. I mean, look at him roll out with authority. That ball is a little bit behind him, but Perry, good hand, strong catch, gets out of bounds too to save some clock. And another timeout for Hartley, so really nice job.
Yeah, that was all set up perfectly where the wide side was the easier side for him to roll out and make that throw. First down and 10. Hand it off, Lathan. Oh, he gets Matt at the line. Maybe didn't even get to the line before he gets drug down.
Boy, that is just a really, really good tackle by the defensive player.
That, again, is Max Shulaw.
Yeah. Yeah, if you don't know who Max Shulaw is, he's a state champion wrestler. You can see why with that. Boy, I saw him. Saw him win that state title with the shot this past March, and whew, he's a big boy. You can see right there, he's sure-handed on those tackles.
Second down, Lathan again. This time he tries to cut it to the inside, and kept on powering as far as he could go, and that's down to almost a 9.
Yeah, but the clock's running. You're inside 30 seconds. All right, there's the timeout. I was wondering when that was going to come, but that's a good run though. That's the kind of run that Lathan normally has. That patient run, follow the blockers, push it for 5 yards. So now you're inside the 10, 28 seconds, no more timeouts. You know, you got to think throwing is the way to go here, but if you do run, you've got to rush to the line and spike it pretty quick, which is possible.
They put 32 seconds on the clock, so they're going to put 4 more seconds on the clock. They say that's when the timeout was called.
Yeah, I do like that run, though, by Lathan. That's really good blocking. Shout out to Zach Parker there, the lineman really leading the way there, as well as Blake Wyatt. Really nice job. That's the kind of running I think Hartley would love to do down the field as well. But again, we get 32 seconds, 3rd and 5, whole playbook's open. I think, yeah, you can run the ball here if you want to, but if you don't get the first down, it's a quick 4th down call you got to have ready to go. If you get the first down, you spike it and leave yourself time for some more plays. But you're in field goal range here too, so you can do that as well if you do pass the ball and throw it incomplete.
Got to come out of here with points.
I completely agree. You don't want to go to halftime feeling like you let something slip away here when you get this close to the end zone.
That's right, because that's negative momentum for you, positive for them, and they get the ball to start the second half.
Absolutely.
32 seconds on the clock. Gullich up under center. Drops back, wants to throw, and he does to the middle, and that ball is incomplete.
I tell you, from our angle, that looked like a perfect throw to Perry. Maybe with a little bit in front of him. I'll have to see that replay. It was a nice slant. And I like that play call, too, because you trust Perry to be able to get off the line and get in front of his defender with a good throw. You think that's going to be a touchdown. Let's see. And he's thrown him to a spot. Oh, yeah, it's just a little bit in front of him. But, boy, it looked like it might have been catchable. Either way, I love the play call. Execution just wasn't there.
So the Hawks will attempt the extra point. Earned the extra point. Going to attempt the field goal, for crying out loud. Going to kick it from the 15-yard line, and it's a high snap.
It's a fake.
Gullich throws it incomplete.
Yeah. It was a fake the whole way, but that pass was not in front of, I can't tell who exactly that was supposed to go to. Yeah, okay, Perry. So that was supposed to go to Ryan Perry. Yeah, look at this pass. It's going to be toward, again, his right shoulder. You want to throw this closer to the sideline. Yeah, and yeah, actually, good job by Perry there. He just tipped that ball so it couldn't be picked off and maybe head the other way. So, again, you don't leave with points. That's unfortunate. Because, boy, that was a very, very promising drive to end the half. I guess if you take any positive here is that you never gave DeSales the ball back in really good chance to score. But, boy, you get that close, you want to find a way to get points on the board.
And Day will just kneel on it with 24 seconds left in the half, and that will do it. So a hard-fought first half. You mentioned last year this game ended with the Sales winning 7-2. And this isn't that, but it's not that far off.
No. 7-2 last year, so this feels like a score fest. But, no, this has been a defensive struggle. Really nice job by both D's, really bottling up the offense. But we'll see which offensive sides kind of change up their play calling a little bit. both teams I know are furious with the way their offenses are rolling. Hartley's got more yards, but haven't been able to punch it in as many times as they'd like. And then DeSales really hasn't gotten anything going. So they have to figure out some way to get the ball moving.
Well, the thing about DeSales is they found some running here a little bit. They're passing. I think they're in a spot where they probably want to pass it a little bit more so that they can open up their run game a little bit. Hartley just wants to run it whatsoever.
Yeah.
And, you know, they've used the pass to kind of do that a little bit. But this is not going to be, for the coaches especially, this is not going to be go catch your breath. This is going to be, hey, this is what are we doing here?
Absolutely.
And how are we fixing this?
We talked about both these teams love a good physical style, right? So, yeah, this is not going to be kick your feet up, let's relax. This is, all right, what are we going to do here? How do we get the ball to Lathan and get him some more yards? These two-yard gains need to be five-yard gains. If you're DeSales, the passing offense has got to get moving at all. Because, like I said, they're running the ball, but if they get in third and five or more, they can't get a completed pass to save their life right now. So this is that time to figure those plays out because this game is it's up for either one.
So the first half is over, and halftime is upon us here at Jack Ryan Field. The Hawks got the first touchdown, and they missed the extra point. DeSales with a pick six, and then they blew their extra point attempt, and that's why we are where we are score-wise here. Halftime at Bishop Hartley, Hawks 6 and DeSales 6. You're watching Bishop Hartley Hawks football on Yamo Media.
Today's highlights are being presented by The Mortgage Captain. Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331 to start your home buying journey. By Yamo Sports and Yamo Media. The new app is available next week. Find it on the App Store and Play Store. By Training ABC. Create training courses for your organization. Visit trainingabc.com. Page Tech Lemonade, virtual, live events, multimedia. And by Jenny Osman, proud Hartley alumni from the class of 2000 and your realtor from Core Realty Collection.
Kicking off our halftime entertainment, the St. Francis DeSales High School Marching Band. Thank you.
Thank you.
Today's highlights are being presented by The Mortgage Captain. Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331 to start your home buying journey. By Yamo Sports and Yamo Media. The new app is available next week. Find it on the App Store and Play Store. By Training ABC. Create training courses for your organization. Visit trainingabc.com. Page Tech Limited. Virtual, live events, multimedia. And by Jenny Osman, proud Hartley alumni from the class of 2000 and your realtor from Core Realty Collection.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Bishop Hartley Marching Band's 2023 halftime show, Rock and Roll All Night. For tonight's halftime entertainment, the band is going back to the open in the era of ripped jeans, flannel tees, and messy hair of 90s grunge. To open our show, here's Smells Like Teen Spirit. Entertainment, we're going back to the era of big hair and even bigger vocals. This 1980 hit will be sure to get you moving. Here's another one, Bites the Dust. Thank you. endless songs, which was popular upon its release in 1981, even made its way back to the mainstream with the TV show Glee. Featuring soloist Matt Sheridan on alto sax, Jake Fisher on mellophone, here's Don't Stop Believin'.
Welcome to the 32nd Evening of Excellence. Give a round of applause. Thank you up front at $2,500. Round of applause. Thank you for your donation, sir.
All the students and staff and administration of Hartley and alums, thank you so much for being here for the Evening of Excellence. Have a good night. We'll see you next year.
You know, I was watching that Evening of Excellence promo there, and I thought I saw a young Harry Belafonte, but...
Thanks, Bob. Appreciate it. You don't get who that is.
I want to hear you sing later.
No.
Bob McElligott, Matt Barnes with you here at Jack Ryan Field on the campus of Bishop Hartley High School. Hartley and DeSales, great rivals, and they are tied 6-6, each team getting a touchdown in the first half, each team missing out on their extra point in the first half. Hartley, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half of this game. The running game is usually a highlight for them, but this is the best run they had all night, man.
Yeah.
Because there was nobody trying to tackle anybody right there.
The sales defense has been in the way from the jump. And boy, the defense has played well for Hartley. They technically not given up a point at all. The only points have come for a pick six. So the Hartley defense has been stout from the jump. This was a huge play here. DeSales' best drive inside the red zone. Xavier Martin Fuller with the interception on an overthrow by, well, more of a miscommunication with the receiver from R.J. Day to the receiver. But then again, the turnover for Hartley here, that was a big one because that gave DeSales good ball in the ball, good position, defense held. But again, here's one of the plays of the game. At a time when the offense couldn't get moving, Robert Lathan finally finds the gap, gets a huge, huge gain. Some positive momentum for the Hawks, and they cap it off with this touchdown pass.
Oh, look at this touchdown pass to Ryan Perry. Boom! On the mark.
Yeah, and that's what you want to see. See if the run game can open up the passing game, and it was doing that. Extra point, again, no good. It was a little bit too low. Not many extra points going to go when it's going right there.
So we're getting set to start the second half. And DeSales. Ready to kick it off. They go with a squib kick. And a high bouncer taken at the 23-yard line. And the Hawks are going to get it up to the 30-yard line. Oh, they stay in possession and get it up to the 45. What a return right there by Bishop Hartley's Joey Wooten.
How about that, right? I mean, that looked like he was going to go down around the 30-yard line. Bounces off the tackle, and I think even DeSales kind of gave up on this. Yeah, that's number 23 there, Max Shula. Normally a short tackle. We've seen that all throughout the game. Couldn't bring him down. An extra 15, 17 yards by Wooten. And with an offense that's been struggling to really get big gains and get first downs at times, those 17 yards on a kickoff return could be massive. Great second effort.
Absolutely. Great field position to start things. Matt Gulich, your quarterback. Hands it off. Robert Lathan. Oh, and he picks his way through the right side, and he's going to be out of bounds at the 44-yard line, I think is where they're going to mark it.
And nice job following the blockers there. Watch this gap again. This lane open up for Lathan. Can get patient running, waiting for that block to hit, waiting for that block, and then boom. Doesn't get touched until right there, and it's 7 yards down the field. See if they can keep that going because that's going to be their key to victory. Ball control and getting big. Big gains on first down.
Well, the ball's on the ground, and Gulich is able to pounce on it. He's going to lose a couple here, and he's disappointed by that. But the good news is he keeps the football.
Again, that center to quarterback exchange has been trouble the last few weeks. This one looks like it's all on Gulich, though. That ball looks like it's right in his hands and just dropped right there. Boy, and that's unfortunate because second and three, and it looked like Ralston already had the block ready to go. And just needed Lathan to go behind him for an easy first down yardage.
Goes from third and three to third and five. Right near midfield. And again, another mishandling of the exchange, and Lathan is down back at the 45-yard line.
Well, a promising drive goes backward very, very quickly. I mean, that was as ugly as it gets right there. Again, fumbled snap, lucky to get it back. And then a bit of a dangerous pitch to Lathan, who obviously had nowhere to go. And nice job by DeSales to make sure that broken play didn't turn anything else. But boy, that's disappointing for Hartley after two plays that looked like seemingly you were going to really be able to move the ball, or one play moving the ball, and the last two were fumbled snaps.
There's the punt taken at the 25-yard line, and there's a flag immediately thrown. So the first bit of contact didn't take long.
Yeah, just that sideline warning on the Hawks.
Well, Davis Anderson was the guy receiving the kick.
And like you said, good kick coverage by the Hawks. Right when he caught the ball, was taken down there by, it looked like, Julian Elliott. So tough first drive for the Hawks. Again, started with that first down run that looked like they were kind of getting the run game going. But again, until that quarterback center exchange starts working, it's not going to work well.
DeSales spreads it out. Four receiver set. Lone set back behind the quarterback, Day. And he hands it off. And they come to the near side. And they're going to get up over the 35 to the 36-yard line. Again, Avery Garlock. The only points that DeSales has gotten tonight has come from their defense. And it was this interception and return for a touchdown that got them their touchdown earlier in the first half.
Yeah, Elijah Charles has jumped that route. Passed a little bit behind by Matt Gulledge. And that was a huge play for DeSales because, frankly, on offense, they haven't really been able to get a long drive going. And when the defense gets you points, that gives you a little bit of juice on offense. I think now you got to do your part.
Garlock again up over the 40 to the 41. He's got a first down.
And again, that's what DeSales wants to do. They want to get him going. All right, because if you have to start playing him up the tackle there, that opens up the outside for Day to maybe find one of his wide receivers, maybe for a chance to scramble inside, or even more important for them, the read option. He can fake it to Garlock. If Hartley over pursues that, then he can get to the outside, maybe pop a pass to the outside. So a lot of options if they can get the run game going with number zero.
Give it to him again. Looking left side, bounces off the first would-be tackler, and he gets to the 45. Garlock's a big boy, 6'1", 205 pounds. I mean, he's got some meat on the bones as he comes into that line.
Yeah, sure does. You can see, like, the bounce off right here, boom, runs into his guy, and then still finds a way to fall forward. Brendan Lorette with the tackle there. But, again, after a gain of three, DeSales staying down a distance they like here. You know, second and seven doesn't hurt you. Second and ten is where you start having to maybe call some plays that you're not as comfortable with.
Defense thought the offense had moved, but Garlock takes the ball, and he's not going to get much. Tried to turn the corner. Good pursuit by the Hawks to bring him down.
Yeah, it looked like Roy Ralston that time, the linebacker, getting outside the tackle there and chasing him down from behind, not letting him get much more than a yard or two. So now another big down here for the Hartley defense to see if they can get this DeSales offense off the field. And if you're DeSales, yeah, you got the run game going a little bit here, but you're going to have to pass the ball eventually. And here's a passing down. Can RJ Day find somebody?
Fakes the handoff, wants to throw. Now he tries to run, and he's going to be dropped for a loss. And that's what has happened almost every time tonight that he has needed to make a pass. There was pressure, and again, it's Donovan Davis. He's been the guy all evening.
Yeah, I mean, he's been able to get by the line. I mean, look at this. I mean, he's being blocked, but right when Day's looking to run, gets off his block and gets that tackle. You see Denham Cook there also involved in the play. Yeah, Day just hasn't been able to find anyone open at all. You think he's trying to get rid of that ball quick. So if his first and second read aren't open, he's looking to run. Nice job by the line. They're not over-pursuing too much, and they're allowing him to have to just kind of take the sack or get short yardage.
There's a short kick. It bounces, and DeSales will let it continue to roll, and it'll come down to about the 32.
Well, it's funny. It's a 6-6 game, and in many ways it feels like Hartley's dominating the play. I mean, great. Their offense isn't moving the ball up and down the field every time, but they definitely are leading in the yardage battle because the DeSales offense hasn't had a real long, sustained drive. Hartley's had two or three, and they just, again, haven't been able to punch it into the end zone. So, yeah, it just doesn't feel lopsided.
Yeah, here's where they could have gotten points right at the end of the first half. They went with a fake field goal and then the pass just off the mark there to Ryan Perry.
Yeah, that was right at the end of the half, too, about 30 seconds left. You're thinking they might take the halftime lead, and then they don't.
Boy, there would look to be room in the middle that time, and then it was gone.
Yeah, and then the rugby scrum pursuits. I mean, all 11 guys on DeSales are in that tackle. That is astounding.
Now, DeSales came out of there with the football, but the officials are saying the whistle was blown. The play was dead.
Yeah, that forward progress was stopped 5 seconds before that.
It's only a gain of one.
Here again, this is DeSales pretty much daring the Hawks to pass the ball. And Ryan Perry, I wouldn't play with fire too much. If they're going to single cover him, I wouldn't be surprised to see the Hawks throw one deep and see if DeSales can cover the speedster on the outside.
It is second down and nine. Going to hand it off. Winbush around the near side. They're finally able to turn the corner, and he's going to get into DeSales territory before being brought down inside the 35.
See, and I love that play call there, too, because they've been trying that jet sweep left and right, but this time it's blocked so well on the outside. There's Ryan Perry there. A couple others, too. Who's that? That is Robert Lathan. Excuse me. Yeah, Robert Lathan on the outside with the block, and then Winbush does the rest with his speed. Really nice job. And the timing was perfect on that quarterback center and exchange right to Winbush on the run. Really, really nicely done. And the Hawks get a big gain on that jet sweep.
They say he stepped out at the 37-yard line. That's where the Hawks take the football. Here's Lathan. Breaks through the first tackle. Puts his shoulder down. He'll take what yardage he can get. It's not much, but he gets some.
Yeah, I mean, frankly, when they pitched the ball to him, well, that's all the wall of gray and white, so I'm surprised he even got any positive yardage. That was really nicely done. I mean, I think this play is supposed to be designed to go inside, and then he has to bounce it outside and does a nice job getting around Elijah Charles there and finding a few more yards before heading out of bounds. Lathan's just such a patient runner that on plays like that, it really helps. So he's not just diving right into the back of somebody. Instead, he's waiting to see if he can find a lane to get some yards.
Turned it into a four-yard gain. And now they just set up the triple I, and there's another bad snap. Or a bad exchange. Not a bad snap, a bad exchange.
Yeah, and again, it seems inexcusable that in week eight, this keeps happening. And I know that's how not only Brad Burchfield and the coaching staff feels, but I'm sure it's how Matt Gallage feels. The fact that they can't connect on these consistently. Because it's so frustrating when you know you've got the offense going and then it's pretty much a free down that you're just giving away to the defense when you just have to fall on the ball. Thankfully, at least they fall on it and it's not a turnover this time.
But now it leaves you with a third down and seven.
And once again, you know, whole playbook's open here. You're kind of in four down territory. We're inside the 40 here, but boy, you would have liked this to be third and three, third and two instead.
Going to hand it off to Lathan, trying to come around the near corner. And again, he gets what they give him. They don't give him much.
No, they don't give him much. And again, nice job by him just getting any kind of positive yardage. The sales just doing a really nice job of staying on their assignments and not letting any of these kind of misdirection, jet sweeps, kind of these handoffs go too far. Strung him out outside just enough. Nice job by Elijah Charles. Played his edge as he should. And so now, yeah, a long fourth down for the Hawks offense. And it's just not ideal for what they like to do.
I love what he did there, though. He came to a stop. He could have just cruised out of bounds. Mm-hmm. Because he came to a stop and shifted his weight back to his left, he picked up an extra yard.
Yep.
Here's a throw. Perry's got it. And Perry's got the first down. Ryan Perry's got the touchdown.
Listen, you throw that ball to about any other receiver, he's getting tackled within 2 yards of catching that ball. Ryan Perry's so quick. He made a cut to the inside, and he was gone. Oh, man, I can't wait to see this replay to see that move because that was fantastic. Oh, man. I mean, look at this move right there. Boom. Oh, the two DeSales players hit each other, and they miss Perry, who cruises to the end zone. Oh, just a fantastic play by him. Listen, that's why he's such a weapon.
And then, and you saw Gullidge there. He had a man on him. That was great patience to bring that defender all the way until he was making contact and unloaded the ball.
Again, that's well done. Those two have such great chemistry. And, you know, I'm sure that's a play they've worked on many times, but it still takes Perry making that kind of move to make it, instead of being a short gain, to a special play and a touchdown.
Timeout is called by Hartley here.
Yeah, I think they're going to go for two, and they just never really seemed comfortable and running out of time on the play clock there.
Well, there was a big discussion that was going on with the officials. They still had the yard marker back at about the 30-yard line.
And I didn't know if for a second I thought there was a flag and they were discussing something, but maybe it was just as simple as where they want to spot the ball in terms of left, middle, right hash. But, I mean, whatever it was, it wasted half the play clock.
It did. Let's take a look again at this.
I mean, it's that cut right there. Boom. I mean, he set it up too. He leaned right and then cut left. Oh, the poor DeSales defenders. That's a helpless feeling because you know you're right there to make that tackle. And right when you dive, all you see is your guy and the other guys behind you running away from you.
Hawks missed the extra point the first time that they got a touchdown. So they'll go for two here, try to get it to 14. And there's so many times that you think, well, you only got to get it in from the three. The running game is great. This is, you know, you don't get it every time, but this is not the hardest thing in the world to do. But the way the running game has gone tonight, getting 3 yards has been tough.
Yeah, no kidding.
Well, they've got Joey Wooten in there right now. They don't have Gullich, the quarterback, in there. And they snap it to Lathan, and he's going to cut to the middle. Did he get in?
I don't think so. And the ball is out. Yeah, he's short.
So they're going to call him down at the one-yard line.
But, yeah, you were right in that Joey Wooten's the one who took that snap. So it made me think that he was either going to hand it off and block, or he was just going to kind of quarterback sneak it a la Jalen Hurts style. And I don't know, whatever it was, didn't work because DeSales got such a great push on the line. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's closer than I thought, actually. He's right there on the one and just couldn't get that final yard over.
So they don't get any points. It's 12-6. And there you see it.
Yeah, so it's Lathan who got the ball but just couldn't push far enough. And, yeah, it's where he reaches there. That's where the ball comes loose even though he's already down. But yeah, he's down at the one and just doesn't have that long enough reach to break the plane.
So you got to go back to relying upon the defense here.
Which has been a good thing to rely on. This defense has been stout the entire game. Besides, again, that first drive where they gave up a lot of yards, they have not given up much at all. And R.J. Day has just seemed very uncomfortable in the pocket. If he has to pass the ball, he's got to get rid of it in the first 2 seconds or he has had nothing. So that's why it's so imperative for DeSales to get that running game going so they can give themselves third and manageable and be able to run the ball instead of having to force themselves on third and long and having to pass it.
Well, let's see where this kick goes. It was a short little, not a squib kick, but they like to chip it down to about the 30, 35-yard line and get a bounce.
Yeah, Connor Bjornson's gotten better and better at this with each and every game, it seems like, and where to place this ball.
And here he is again, a little chip shot. This will be taken, though, at the 30, and a breaking attack, went up over the 40, 50-yard line. We got a flag that's thrown behind the play as Davis Anderson was the man on the return.
Yeah, and whatever that flag was, two referees saw it, so that made me think it's maybe a block in the back or a hold. So that long return is all for naught, and DeSales kind of still be back in their own territory.
It is holding on the receiving team.
Yeah, it looks like it's on number 15. Yep, just saw it right there on that replay there. That is on Adam Faulkner. He's holding on to a Jay Zhang there as the returner was starting to go by.
Well, the way that Jay Zhang plays, sometimes you have to hold on to him if you don't want him to make a play because he's hunting for the play.
Yeah, he's like his helmet's on fire. He is always moving, man. Always moving.
So they put the ball back to the 34-yard line. So as you said, that was a long return. That would have been into Hartley territory at about the 35.
Absolutely. It's about a 30-yard penalty once you mark all the yards off.
R.J. Day, freshman quarterback, St. Francis DeSales, running this offense. He wants to throw. Again, running out of time, and again, he'll go down. Mm.
Yeah, that's just good play by Joey Wooten there on the right side of the line. Couldn't be blocked, and then he's right on RJ Day's back. I don't even know if he saw him coming. He just felt him as he was about to pass the ball. Yeah, look at them just blow up the blocker there. That's Jonathan Brown who's trying to hold him up, but Wooten said, I'm a heat-seeking missile, and he got to him quickly. And before Day could even get comfortable, he was on the ground.
That's pretty impressive. I mean, a lot of times you get to the quarterback, you don't carry the running back with you.
Exactly.
Here's a handoff, and again, nothing doing. And that is the same guy we were just talking about there, Jonathan Brown.
Yeah. And that is Roy Ralston, who got his hands on him and wouldn't let him go. I mean, look at him get in the backfield as quick as he did. I mean, this is impressive stuff. You can see him right there. He's creeping in, and then boom. Meets him right there. Almost took the handoff from the quarterback. That's how quickly Ralston was in there. That's your senior linebacker making a big play And now third and long, and this is just not where DeSales wants to be.
No.
Because Day just has not been able to get the ball downfield because, one, he hasn't had time, or two, just doesn't feel comfortable throwing the ball if his guy's not open.
Two safeties deep. They're going to throw it near side. That is caught. And there's some running room, but not much. Being tackled is Nolan McSweeney. He got it back past the original where the ball was spotted originally, but it's still going to leave him about third or fourth down and six or seven.
Yeah, yeah. I like the play call, though, because third and 17, you don't feel comfortable him throwing it deep. Why not set up a screen pass? It looked like he had the blocking in front of him, but, boy, we need 17 yards. That's a lot to ask for, and McSweeney couldn't pick it all up. So a nice gain. You know, you'll take that as you have to punt the ball here. But, again, that was all set up by the first two plays where DeSales was going backward thanks to the Hartley defense pursuit.
Oh, they just got that punt away. This is a good punt. And Hartley decides to let it bounce. That was almost disastrous, but pick it up and get it back across the 30 to the 31. The ball came out. They say the ball carrier was down by contact.
Yeah, that was Ryan Perry who made that a little heart-stopping for the Hartley fans there because that ball dropped to his feet. Oh, man.
Yeah.
I don't know if he lost it in the lights or what happened there, but he's lucky that ball didn't hit his feet and then kick out further. He kind of just died where he was, but whew. He's very sure-handed even as a returner. We know he's as a receiver, so a little surprising to see him let that drop right there.
Now this offense coming off a touchdown in their last possession. Trying to run it. Lathan reverses field here, and there's still nothing there for him.
Yeah. I can't get enough credit to this DeSales defensive front. They've done such a great job bottling Lathan up about 99.5% of these carries. Again, he's a nice, patient runner, always looking for that lane, but it just hasn't been there most of the game. And, you know, in that case, this time he sees the lane or doesn't see a lane, so he tries to bounce it outside, and still nothing out there. So kudos to that entire front and linebackers as well because they've been crashing in to make sure he doesn't get past that line of scrimmage.
They put Gullich in the shotgun this time. And he fakes the handoff and the throw. Ball is caught. Winbush just with a little slant play there.
See, and that's a play I've always liked from them. If they go to the shotgun, that little quick pass, because these receivers are so fast, you have to play off of them. You're giving them 5-6 yards of cushion. Watch Winbush here. Just boom. Put your foot in the ground, go in a nice slant. That's a great 6-yard gain. And DeSales can't do anything about it because they have to honor the speed of Winbush there. So as long as you like the timing and, you know, you trust your quarterback to make that pass, maybe in a little bit of traffic, boy, that's now you're in third and manageable.
And that manageable is 4 yards. They pitch it to Lathan, and he gets going, and he's got the first down. He's got more. Cross the 50 to the 48 before he's brought down.
Yeah, I think everyone in the stadium knew this was going to be a big gain right when he pitched it. The blockers were already in front of him, and, you know, whether DeSales on the lined up correctly or Hartley saw something they liked, they knew this was going to work immediately. Watch this. So you've got Perry on the outside blocking that guy. I mean, look, Wood's looking for someone to block. And there's still another lineman there. Who's that? That's Nick Ruby looking for someone to block. I mean, Lathan, big gain there. Nicely timed play call there.
Picks up a huge first down. Gets that clock running under 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Hartley looking for another score. Put Wooten in motion. They hand it off. Zhang. He gets hit immediately. He's brought down after a 1-yard gain.
Again, that DeSales defensive front doing a yeoman's job inside the tackle.
It's like they keep coming back and saying, hey, you guys still tough in the middle? Yes. Yes, we are.
But here's the thing. I like it, and I think both Hartley and DeSales would agree. That's what you want to do. You want to continue to try to be physical. You want to try to get that ball up the gut because you may pop that long one, but, you know.
Yeah, it only takes that one time where they're not ready for
exactly.
it.
Exactly. You cannot give up on that, on running it up the middle.
A couple of receivers to the top of the screen here, two to the top, two to the bottom. College again checking with that sideline.
And all I can think of now is as a coach, as a fan, just make sure the snap is good.
And it is. And there's a flag, though, as Joey Wooten turns the corner.
Wow, he went down in a weird way. I thought it was a face mask or something that that brought him down.
Illegal shift on the offense.
I want to see the end of this play. First off, I don't know why the illegal. I don't see the illegal shift, but what's the end of this play? What brings
that was
Perry. That was absolutely a face mask, wasn't it? Oh yeah, no, I see it. Wooten moved, and then Perry was still moving. So yeah, Wooten's got to be set for a full second. But yeah, the end of this play, it sure looks like Perry's grabbed in the face mask and dragged down. Don't see it on that replay, but no flag there.
Which would have offset.
Yeah, exactly. That's why it was a big deal.
Yeah.
Would have saved the 5 yards.
Well, that's been a theme tonight for the Hartley offense at 5 yards. Second and 15 now. Hand it off, and again, nowhere to go.
Nice job by Dane Crabtree there. And again, we've seen DeSales just not be fooled with that play. We've seen about three or four times, and every time it's been no gain, 1 yard at the max.
Yeah, the counter play doesn't play tonight.
No, it's not working at all. And we've seen Hartley run that play so effectively against other teams. It's probably been some of their best plays of the year. But it is not the case this time around, as DeSales really scouted that well and prepared for it each and every time.
Well, that is the final play of the third quarter. So Hartley will continue their offensive drive with a third down and 14 as we head to the fourth quarter here at Jack Ryan Field. The Hawks are in control right now, leading DeSales by the score of 12-6. This is Bishop Hartley football on Yamo Media.
Today's highlights are being presented by The Mortgage Captain. Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331 to start your home buying journey. By Yamo Sports and Yamo Media. The new app is available next week. Find it on the App Store and Play Store. By Training ABC. Create training courses for your organization. Visit trainingabc.com. PageTech Lemonade. Virtual, live events, multimedia. And by Jenny Osman, proud Hartley alumni from the class of 2000 and your realtor from Core Realty Collection.
Well, Bishop Hartley Open House is coming up on Thursday, November 9th, 6:30 to 8:30. Great opportunity for those in the feeder schools to come in and get a good look at Bishop Hartley, the school, meet the personnel. So mark it down, November 9th. Hawks right now. Gollich wants to throw, and he unloads one toward Ryan Perry, but it's behind him and falls incomplete.
Yeah, he had gotten behind the defender by a bit, but he was so well covered. Nicely done there by DeSales. That's Eliza Hood on the coverage. Again, third and 14, not where you want to be. Don't mind taking a shot there, seeing if you can get the ball to your speedster. Now he's got to hustle back and get ready for a punt. Decent drive there by the Hawks, but again, not all what they wanted for sure. That penalty kind of set them back when, again, you don't want second and 15. You like to keep that to second and 7, second and 6 to really keep that offense humming.
Perry kicks it away. And that is going to chase back Anderson. It goes off his fingertips, picks it back up, and the kick coverage is excellent.
Yeah. That's a mistake by Davis Anderson. That ball was, if he's trying to catch, he's trying to catch it above his helmet. And by doing that, it allowed for that to make it a tougher catch than necessary. And boy, great job of the kick coverage.
Brendan Lorette with the tackle. Just look at him track him down back at the 5 yard line.
Yeah, really, really nice job by the kick coverage there. And great punt by Perry, too. I tell you, he's gotten off some good ones today. And if you're catching the ball inside your 10 like Anderson was there, boy, sometimes you just want to kind of let that one go. See if it rolls into the end zone for a touchback. But, boy, if this DeSales offense didn't have enough struggles, now you're starting inside the 5 yard line. Yikes.
Day with a handoff. I mean, not a lot of running room there.
Yeah. Jonathan Brown that time, right? Yeah. And there's nowhere to go. And here's the thing. If you're the Hartley defense, I think, and there's, coaches are much smarter than me, but you're going to let RJ Day beat you at this rate, right? I mean, you're going to play for that run because that's, I think, the thing that's going to hurt you the most. RJ just hasn't looked comfortable back there. Hasn't been able to get off a real good pass because frankly, every time the defensive front's right there and is catching. So I think you got to really make sure you're sure tackling on these running backs, because that is where they're going to make their hay on offense right now.
Hand it off to him again. Goes over the left side. There's a hole. Look out. And there goes down the field, far side, Jonathan Brown. He's inside the 40, the 30. The Hawks have one last ditch chance to get him, and he is going to be down at the one-yard line.
Oh, man, and that's exactly what I meant. That's the only thing that seemed like that could hurt the Hawks right now, is something like a long run, because the passing game wasn't doing much. The run game had an opportunity to do just that. And, boy, that is such a huge, huge play all the way down to the one-yard line. Oh, man. But now what is this right here?
Well, there's where he gets free, and then he's...
No.
Ooh.
All right, well, that silent interference call is a big call. It doesn't ruin the play. The play still went all the way to the one-yard line, but it does move the ball from the one to the six. So that is a big call in that way. So there's no guarantee you're going to get a touchdown coming from the six-yard line. It's a lot easier from the one. But, boy, look at that right there. Just there's enough of a gap, and Hartley was, again, selling out for that run like I thought they might. But, boy, he got past the second level, and away goes Jonathan Brown. Great pursuit, though, by Fidelis Ajoma to preventing that touchdown. Because now if you get a four, you know, you get a stop down here and four downs, you're going to remember that tackle that he made there on that what should have been a touchdown.
Garlock, once again, the running back. They hand it off, or they don't hand it off to him. Day keeps it, and he tries to go up the middle, and the Hawks have that sniffed out.
Yeah, nicely done. Sure looked like, actually, if Garlock had it, he might have been able to cut into the end zone there, but instead Day does keep it, and Hawks discipline, doing a really nice job making sure that they get to Day. Almost got him before a little loss there, but, yeah, nice job by Ralston, Jay Zhang there. Making sure they get him down. Boy, such a big set of downs here for DeSales and for the Hawks.
Gained 1 yard, second down and four. Man comes in motion, fake the handoff to him. Day up the middle toward the end zone. Hawks try to keep him out, and they do.
Yeah, yet again, fakes the handoff on the jet sweep. He decides to go up the middle. Gets a little bit, but not enough. So now third down and goal. And the Hawks defensive front doing just enough right now. But this is where it gets tough. Third and really short. You can see DeSales bringing in a little bit of a bigger package now. Maybe don't spread it out as much. See if they can punch it in. It's just tough running against the likes of Donovan Davis and Denham Cook and those guys in the middle there. Now they've brought in Patrick Javetsky. He's a big guy in the middle of that line. See which team can be more physical at the line of attack.
Hand it off, Shuloff, and he is stopped.
Boy, that is a great, great job. You can see Denham Cook is fired up about that, and he should be, because that's not an easy man to bring down. Sometimes it's who's got the stronger legs. In this case, Denham Cook just stood up Shuloff and would not let him go forward. Boy, nice job underneath, too. You see 45, Jay Zhang there's got his leg. Denham Cook's got the top. Whoa, what a huge play here. Can the Hawks keep him out of the end zone?
Fourth down and one. The handoff. And this time, DeSales is in for the touchdown. Shuloff gets a second chance and makes good on it.
Gets around the left side and does just enough and stays on the feet and gets across the goal line. So they do cash in. It took four plays, but that's all that matters. DeSales finds a way to tie this game up and take advantage of that huge, huge run by Jonathan Brown. Watch this replay again. Great blocking on the edge there. And when you only need a yard, Shuloff just puts his head down and finds a way to get that yard. So big extra point here, though. We saw the last one not go well. Looks like they have a different kicker here, too.
Leo Amalaman, left-footed kicker. But there's a flag. This is going against Hartley. We'll move it half the distance.
Now, the last time we had the extra point with the sales, it was a snap that was the issue. Went right over the holder's head.
Jeffrey Fields is a long snapper. coming out of the half, he was practicing on the sidelines.
They were practicing indeed. Yeah, Brendan Ballard saying, hey, man, help me help you get that ball to my hands and not over my head.
This time it is a good snap. Another flag, though.
And I think this one's going to be on the offense.
False start.
Boy, and if you're Ryan Wiggins of DeSales, you're just thinking, come on. Just need one of these. Because with each and every snap, there's another opportunity for this to go wrong.
That's
for
right.
you.
That's right. That kick was good. It would have been good.
Yeah, and had plenty of legs. So these 5 yards shouldn't be a problem. But, again, it's less the kicker's length that I think you're worried about if you're DeSales. It's making sure the snap and hold go correctly.
Now we're going to kick it from the 15-yard line. And it is a bad snap. And it's picked up, and now it's going to be picked up by the Hawks, but again, that play is dead. Emoji can run it down the field. It will not matter. It's a dead ball. But you called it.
You play with fire that many times, and, oh, man. And you, I mean, it's unfortunate, but that's why penalties hurt so much, because they give you that second chance to possibly make a mistake. Oh, man. And they tried so hard to practice that during the half, but nerves get to you at those big moments, and that's where it happened right there. It was a high snap. I'm sure Ballard would say he thought he could get that ball down, but he could not. And, yeah, again, in high school, that play is dead. You cannot return it for those 2 points like you can in college and pro. It's unfortunate because that would have been an easy 2 points for the Hawks.
And two maybe necessary points.
Yeah. here we are again, tied at 12.
And it's just this kind of game. Like, it was actually easy for you to set up because as you're watching it, you're going, you know this is going to be messed up. Yeah. It's just, you know there's going to be a mistake here.
Yeah, it's just.
After the second penalty.
Yeah, both these teams have kind of found a way to get in their own way, unfortunately. And it's just that kind of game. But, listen, that's what makes high school football great. You learn from these mistakes. Both these teams will tell you, you don't want to win this game badly, but, boy, you really want to make sure you avoid these mistakes come week 11 when it's win or go home time.
So 12-12 is our score. 8 minutes and 20 seconds left on the clock here in the fourth quarter. Line drive kick. And this one will be taken inside the 5, up over the 10 to 15. And we've got a flag. And this is against Hartley. It's a block in the back, and now they're going to have the long field in front of them.
Yeah. Have to go 90 yards to get a touchdown. And, again, moving the ball has not been easy for the Hawks. Some drives easier than others. Other drives have been three and out. So this is going to be a big penalty. Let's watch it again.
This is another one where I'm thinking what you had said earlier. Maybe just let that thing skip through the end zone.
Yep. And if it doesn't get there, then pick it up. But, I mean, yeah. where he picked it up, you got to think. I mean, he picked it up around the 3-yard line. That's
going
to roll
in
then. Yeah. Yeah, and then you get the ball at the 20 and go
no
from there.
No block in the back.
Yep.
No. Start clean.
Yeah.
But that's not this game.
No.
This game tonight is pick it up at the 1, block in the back, yep. move to the 10,
yep.
and maybe go 90.
Yep,
I don't know.
Exactly. Yeah.
I have no
Fumbled
idea.
Fumbled snap here. Wasted opportunity here. That's what makes it great.
Fake field goal off the fingertips over there.
You can't script this stuff.
No, you cannot. And you know what? It's the thing. This is the stuff that will frustrate the heck out of high school coaches, mm-hmm. but it's also what makes high school football entertaining.
Absolutely does.
Gallup's running this offense, and he pitches it back. They're going to try to run to the near side, and not much there as out of bounds goes Perry.
Yeah, just not enough room on that field to get around the corner. He was starting
Actually,
to turn it.
He got more than I thought he got.
Let's see, about 3 or 4 yards. Yeah, I mean, again, and if you're hardly 3-4 yards is all you really want on first down. Yeah, just couldn't get around the corner enough. But he's quick enough to be able to, you know, outrun that last defender to the edge and find a way to get, again, 4 yards on that first down carry.
Well, this is a big down right here. Been a lot of mishandled snaps. They get this one cleanly. And it's Lathan. Here he comes, churning for the first down across the 30-yard line.
Yeah, I want to see this replay because I think Roy Ralston is the one who gives him the lane. Again, Lathan was waiting for the lane to open up, and I think it was Ralston that seals this block. Watch 43 right there, just with the shoulder, actually, is what he does. His shoulder into the gut of the defender, Max Shulaw, and that was all Lathan needed. Went right around him and got the first down. Nicely done. Again, sometimes these blocks that Hartley sets up in their run game take a while to set up. And so you have to be a patient runner, and thankfully Lathan's that guy.
And this is where they need him right now. He's been their best guy out of the backfield all year long. They need yardage. They need to burn the clock. He's the guy that's done it up to this point. They need him right now. He's at 147 yards. He's going to add to that. He's at 150 right there as he picks up three more.
Yeah, just kind of grinding this game out. That's what I think Hartley wants to do right now. All right, you've got this DeSales defense. Probably a little bit tired because, frankly, I would be tired playing this Hartley offense in this rush game. And, you know, your mind's racing, your legs are burning. It's a physical game. So here you are in the last 7 minutes of this ball game, tied. Find a way. And then if you're DeSales, boy, if you can get them in third and long, then you're in good shape here to possibly get the ball back. And, again, you've seen your offense. It takes one good pop to get to the end zone.
Bring a man in motion. Oh, another bad snap, and the ball is down at the 30-yard line.
That hurts. That absolutely hurts. Because, again, now you're in that third and long situation you do not want to be in because your whole playbook is not open anymore. Let's see what happened here. Yeah, I'm not even sure. He was faking to – looks like he's going to possibly hand this ball off, or it's just a – yeah, fake to look like that's Ralston. It's Ralston and just lost the ball. That's unfortunate. So now you're looking at that pass play again.
Third down and 10. Can they pick up this first down? Can they keep this drive going? Just over 6 minutes left here in the fourth quarter. And they pitch it. And that is a nothing play.
No.
In fact, it's a minus play.
Yeah. That looked uncomfortable from the start. First off, it looked like he didn't fully grab that shotgun snap, and even when he pitched it, that ball was fluttering a little bit. Yeah, and then that ball was pitched behind Bryson Winbush, so that didn't help either. So now fourth and very long.
Now you got to punt it, and now DeSales will have the opportunity to come down and get points.
And again, their offense has been struggling the entire game, but as we see, all it takes is one play. Jonathan Brown last time nearly housed it 95 yards on one play. So it's not where you want to be. Get the sales player down with a cramp here. So this will give Hartley a little time to think about making sure they have good kick coverage here.
Well, it's going to take a good kick from Perry and good kick coverage here by the Hawks.
And he's gotten off some really good punts here. Been really, really well done. And obviously the last one, punt returner had some trouble grabbing, and that allowed that ball to roll even further into DeSales territory. So, again, big punt here. Can't afford to get it blocked. Can't afford to shank one here. Got to get one down the field, and then good kick coverage. More yards DeSales got to go, the better, because, again, their offense has been moving the ball quickly besides that one long run. Boy, this... I don't want to say this and jinx myself, but this just feels like an overtime game coming up. It just does.
Part of me hopes you're right now.
Yeah. If DeSales gets the ball, you're right.
Yeah. It's 5:43 left in the fourth quarter. Again, the injured player is still down on the field. And so while we are still in the injury timeout, we'll step aside. 12-12. Hartley into sales, and the Hawks are looking at a fourth down and 15. When we return, you're watching Hartley Hawks football here on Yamo Media.
Everyone knows about Jackie Robinson, Jesse Owens. Everyone's familiar with those names. But Charles W. Follis was an unknown. Until today. My name is Herman Smith, the great nephew to the first professional black football player. The true test of a man's character is what he does when no one is watching. So in a sundown city, the rule is, if you're black.
Ryan Perry with a punt. This is a good punt.
Oh, it's a great punt.
And this ball going to spin inside the 30, down to the 25, and will be down at the 23-yard line. Wow.
Yeah, great punt because it went over the punt returner's head, but then had enough roll to roll another 10 yards. That's exactly what the doctor had ordered if you're the Hawks. Boy, nicely done by Ryan Perry. He's not just doing it with his feet. He's doing it with the legs. What a great kick.
Yes, it is. Just what the doctor ordered for the Hartley Hawks at this point in time. And now it's that defense. They relied on this defense tonight, and they need a big stop right here.
Yep, and again, I think you got to control the run. Make RJ Day beat you with his arm.
And here we go, first down and 10. Day hands it off. Garlock trying to cut back, and he's slowed down and dropped at the 25.
Yeah, nice job there. That's Malik Tufts on the tackle after Garlock did a nice job bouncing off of a couple other tackles. Still a decent gain, but this is where, again, Hawks making sure if you're going to leave DeSales anything on third down, let's make it third down and five or more, because that is where they've really struggled to convert anything.
That was a lot of running for 2 yards.
It was, wasn't it?
Yeah, it really was. Yeah. He got it a couple yards behind the line of scrimmage, so he ran it more than two to get to where he went. And he is back there again, just lined up alongside of Day. Carlock takes it. Up the middle he goes. Gets good yardage this time. Out to the 30. That's going to leave him 3 yards shy of the first down marker.
Yeah, nicely done by Garlock there. Followed his blocks, I should say, and found some running room. And now you leave yourself third and short. That's exactly what you want if you're DeSales. Now you can think about different play calls here. Do you want to have RJ Day possibly run it up the middle, maybe go on the outside, hand it off to Garlock? I don't think you pass ball here, but as you see right now, they've got it five wide and empty backfield. Maybe this is that QB draw. See if RJ Day can get it himself.
He takes it, he throws it near side. That one is tipped and incomplete.
Listen, I know Denham Cook is angry that he didn't pick it off, but I think he should be just as happy, though, that he knocked it down, because that play was open. That pass was intended for P.J. Knowles, and he had just did a little short stop and just stayed right at the sticks. I mean, he's there. Boom. See, he's going to be wide open for that catch, but nice job by Denham Cook. But, again, when you're 6'4", that's a big guy to throw it over. And R.J. Day on the smaller side as a quarterback just couldn't get it up and over those long arms.
Yeah, R.J. Day listed at 6 foot, I think a generous 6 foot.
I think the generous 6 foot as well. He's a freshman. He'll grow.
So Joey Wooten is back. And here is the punt. They just do get it away. This is going to bounce. And take it to sales roll. All the way down to the 15-yard line.
Yeah, you might have been able to hear fans say field that punt, but I'm kind of on Ryan Perry's side there. When that ball's rolling like that and the defender's with 2 yards in front of you, I'm going to let that one
no.
go.
No.
That's
not a chance you're trying to pick up that. That's a hot potato. You just leave that thing go. Let's take a look at the computer rankings after week 7. There you see Hartley, 5-2, ranked third.
Yeah, and according to Joe Idol, they've already clinched the playoff spot. Again, top 16 make it, so it's kind of hard not to make the playoffs, frankly, these days. But Hartley would love to be as high as possible, highest seed. Obviously, not just get that home game the first week, but better competition the rest of the way.
Gallup hands it off, the delayed handoff. Come to the near side, and Winbush run out of bounds.
Yeah, nicely done. Comes up hobbling a little bit. He's going to head back in, though. Nice blocking on the outside by Ryan Perry there. That allowed Winbush to get an extra few yards because of the really solid block. And look at him, just stay on him, stay on him. And that's really well done. Correction, that's Joey Wooten on the block on the outside. Really good.
And Winbush is going to come back out. You mentioned he was hobbling. Mm-hmm. It was like he was sneaking his way back in there. But somebody said, hey, man, if you can't run, let's go.
We got some other we got some other guys who can do it. It's okay.
We got four guys who didn't even touch the ball tonight.
Yeah.
You got to go. Here's a handoff, and Lathan up the middle. He's got the first down. He'll keep coming to the 35.
Yeah, that's a really nice run by Leighton. It's second and short, so I know all they were worried about getting that first down, but what I like about him is that he gets the yard he needs, and then he just keeps on pushing. Again, great block in there. Look at College get in the middle of that mess right there. Nice job, the quarterback getting his hands dirty, allowing him to pick up a few more yards. So nice job by Leighton, and with 3:23 to go here, Hawks have plenty of time to run this ball down the field.
Yeah, they do. I'd like to get a big play. And, you know, they love to play that little 4-yard, 5-yard game. But 3 minutes left. Mm-hmm. At some point, you're going to have to get a big play here. When's it going to come? Here's a handoff. And stopping. Oh, trying to come back. And then DeSales, good job there to make the adjustment by Cameron Gwynn.
Yeah, he's the one who came off with the cramp, and he's back out in the field already. And, again, he's their best defender by far. Watch him play this really, really well. Yeah, that's just, boom, that's a big dude coming at you, too, 6'2", 205. And the other thing, too, with Hartley, I mean, that's a jet sweep toward the short side, so there's not much room to work with there. And once there was no room to go around the edge, he tried to cut back in, and that's when Gwynn met him straight on.
Second down, 10. Hand it off, a little counterplay to Leighton. And he'll come up to the 40-yard line, pick up 5, and that'll leave a third down and 5.
Yeah, good gain there. But, again, with 2:16 to go, third and 5 yards to go, Ryan Wiggins of DeSales sensing a chance to maybe get his offense back on the field and cause that timeout. If you're Hartley, here's your chance. Huddle up. Think of what your best third and 5 play, because this is a huge play right now. Keep this ball in your possession. Give yourself a chance to get down the field.
It's exactly what they have to do. Don't want to give it back here with 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Tie game. Touchdowns, each team's done it twice. Extra points, neither team could do it twice.
And again, how big are those points now for each team? I mean,
and extra points are hardly even thought of in football, right?
Exactly.
It's automatic.
Yeah.
Just give me the 7.
Well, especially in high school, because they're still kicking it from the, you know, from the 10-yard line, whatever it is.
Right.
I mean, it's no big deal, but... Oh, my gosh. Today, DeSales has had 2 bad snaps. Hartley had 1 kicked into the sender, and then the 2-point conversion no good. I mean, this is – it shows you why special teams are so big, because this game could easily be 13-12 for one team, and instead we're all tied up.
Play clock rolling. Third down, 4. And Gullett's trying to use that hard count, see if he can get that free yardage. The answer is no. Winbush comes in motion. They hand it to him. He's trying to get around that right side, and he's got it! Across the 45 to the 47, maybe the 48. It's a first down either way.
So pretty much the same play they had earlier that went to the short side. This time goes to the wide side. So much more room to run, and the block was just fantastic. Look at the cavalcade of gray shirts in front of him. Oh, man. And all he needed was 4, and he found a way to get 6 or 7. That's a nice job to keep this drive moving, keep the DeSales defense on the field. And with 2:09 left, again, still time. Hartley has 2 timeouts. Again, may have to mix in a pass here at some point. And, you know, when you have a guy like Ryan Perry, you can get not just 5 yards, you can get 5, or you can get 10 to 15 on one play. So, decent position here.
Question is here, we were just talking about special teams. Mm-hmm. Can you rely on a field goal attempt to try to win this game?
Yeah, and you know, I don't know the distance that Brad Birchfield feels comfortable kicking a field goal, and then even if you do, you need a good snap and a good hold to make it happen. I think right now you're focused on trying to find a way to get 6 instead of 3.
Yeah, I feel comfortable with a touchdown, personally. Under 2 minutes to play. Low snap. Gollich throws it. That's complete. Over on the far side, and they're going to get it to the 45. Of DeSales.
I'll tell you, so far, I've liked Gollich in the shotgun. I feel like the offense has done pretty good there. You know, whether it's a quick pass or, you know, even a handoff. But the quick pass game for him so far in shotgun, you know, again, they have to play after these receivers a little. So it's allowed him to get rid of the ball quickly without pressure and let these receivers catch the ball and get 3 more yards after the catch, like there.
Takes it, rolls right, or to his left, to the near side. Here's a throw. And Fidelis Amoja makes the catch. He's got the first down.
Boy, see again.
Late flag.
And that should be on DeSales.
Should be a face mask, I think.
Yeah.
Why it took so long, I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know why it did either, because it sure looked like that's the only way they were going to stop him from running even further. He made a great cut.
And it looked like he was going to get by that defender, get a lot of yardage, and then all of a sudden his head jerked back into an awkward position. Let's see. They might be deciding whether to pick this up.
It was funny how far away. Here, we get a look at it right here.
Oh, that might have been Jersey.
Yeah.
That was Jersey's shoulder pad.
I think it initially was there.
Yeah.
Well, they're going to call it.
Yeah. Yeah, I will say on the replay, it looked like he got Jersey, but I will say, too, it looked like his hand grazed the face mask first.
He did, and initially we thought that he grabbed it.
Yeah.
His hand goes across the face mask and then goes to the jersey.
Yeah.
But the flag came in from so far away. It was like the official was waiting. There were two guys closer. Mm-hmm. It was almost like, anybody calling this?
Yeah.
Okay, I guess I've got to call it.
Absolutely.
That's what it appeared to be from here.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it was right or wrong, but they discussed it, and that's what they come up with.
Yeah, same here. I mean, like I said, the replay we showed wasn't 100% conclusive for me to say it was
right
or wrong.
They have no replay
in their defense,
which I'd never defend them, but I will right now.
In this case.
But, again, when you see the hand there
and
you see the way the body turns, I can see where seeing it in real time as a human, you would throw the flag on that.
Absolutely. Now, I will say I'm not sure what this discussion is about because, obviously, you're not taking it back from here. Are we discussing whether the clock starts on snap or on the ready for play? That's all I can think of.
Let's look at it again. You know, while they keep talking, let's take another
one. Yeah, and first off, great pass. I love the pass. He got the first down yardage already, but, yeah, see, it's that hand underneath there.
There was contact underneath there.
Yeah.
But I think he grabbed the jersey, but there was contact. Mm-hmm. His head came up just a little bit, and, again, you're seeing it one time at full speed. That's it.
Yep. So they're deciding between the snap or the ready for play, and it is going to start on the snap. But, yeah, back to Gullich again. That's a nice play. I mean, I love that. Again, the shotgun, the rollout, they're giving him so much room. Emoji catches the ball at 7 yards, and then, boom, he can head upfield. Now you can run the ball. You got two timeouts if you're comfortable running the ball, but I still like that pass game if you want to get a little bit more yardage.
Pitch. Lathan cuts back to the middle. And Lathan all the way down to the 11-yard line.
Yeah, that cutback is what did it right there. What a fantastic move by him. This one wasn't about patience. He had to go. He's on the short side, and the blocking was there. He did a great job just getting upfield, and then it's this cutback that allows him to get 3, 4, 5 more yards. Again, nice blocking, and it cuts back, bowls over a defender, gets the first down yardage. Now you're inside of a minute and in full control here of getting a touchdown with two timeouts.
Funny thing is, I don't want to jinx this either, but the funny thing is you were talking about, I love the passing game, I love the shotgun, and he went under center, and I thought, I like it too because this could be a miscue.
Correct.
And three times tonight we've seen that.
On the shotgun snaps, for some reason, they've been right on the money. Under center has been worth a little dicey, and this is not where you can afford to do that right now, because if you fumble a snap right now, one, you're immediately having to call timeout, and then you're not getting any yards. At least if you run the ball, chance to get some yards, chance to get a touchdown. But a fumble snap would be really, really tough here.
Three times they fumbled the snap tonight. Two times they've gotten it back.
Mm-hmm.
First time it happened, they gave it away. So let's see. And I'm not trying to wish bad on them. We've just watched it all night, right?
Exactly,
Watch it all night.
Yeah, you've seen it with your own eyes, too. And you know it's been a dicey, exchange sometimes between the center and the quarterback.
Look, you've got the game in your hands right now.
Yep.
There's no doubt. You're at the 11-yard line. You've got, 55 seconds on that clock. You've got a great running game. You finally have it working more like the way that you want it to work here. It's all in your hands. Those have got to be sure hands. And here we go. Gullich with the pitch. Latham trying to find his way up the middle, and even though he gets caught from behind, he still is able to lean forward and pick up yardage.
Yeah, I like the yardage there. 4 yards. You're trying to get closer and closer and closer. You're not calling timeout here yet, it looks like. They probably called a play in there. Still have time here, so you don't have to call it. You have two.
And the ball's on the ground, and Gullich has to dive on it at the 16, and now you've got to take that timeout. Or they haven't taken that timeout yet.
And this tells me that Coach Birchfield is waiting for the field goal.
Well, the players want the timeout. The players are...
Well, no, he's already told the referee when he's going to call this timeout.
He looked at that ref and said, you know, around 2 or 3 seconds. There it is. I mean, with literally 1 second left.
So here's the deal.
Wow.
Well, it's third down, and that's showing confidence in your kicker.
Yeah, it is. The only reason I thought you might call a timeout before that is, you know, you have third and 12, third and 13 here. Maybe, again, put yourself a shotgun, quick pass. Make this a little bit shorter.
Well, let's look at this again. Here it is. This is what we talked about.
Yeah, I thought he got out of it clean, but this one, the snap was fine. It's just he went to go turn backward and just bobbled it. Because, yeah, the exchange was absolutely fine. That's unfortunate, though.
And, again, you go from near the 6 back to the 15. That makes this a 32-yard field goal attempt.
It does. Now, granted, we've only seen Connor Bjornsson try one extra point, and it did not go well. But we've seen him do extra points earlier in the season in other games, and he's had plenty of leg to make it from here. This is from the left hash, so it's a little bit of a wide angle here. But, boy, this is what you practice, right?
Yeah.
Good snap, good hold, good kick.
When you sign up to be a kicker, this is the situation that you dream about. The game is on your foot.
And there's
a timeout called by DeSales.
Makes sense. Ice him a little.
You know, my dad always told me when I was a kid, we would play in the backyard. He said, you know, you should be a kicker. Mm-hmm. You're either going to be a hero or a goat. Now, that's before goat meant greatest of all time.
Now it can be both.
You can be the goat now, and it's still positive.
Exactly.
But and I always think every time he sets up in this situation, I think about that. Because, you know, whoever really wants to be the kicker, you want to be the receiver scoring the touchdown. You want to be the quarterback airing it out. You want to be the running back that beats the guy with a good cut. But here we are. Bjornsson has a chance to be a hero tonight.
Absolutely. And here's the thing. If you miss it, at least you're going to overtime. Yep. But here's the chance to be, again, the hero. You can put this game on ice, and this is over. Again, it's not the longest field goal, but it's long enough that, boy, you got to make sure you hit it well. And again, it's just.
They're going to place it. The ball will be placed at the 22-yard line. So, as I said, 32-yard field goal attempt coming up. And let's see if the Hawks can walk it off. That is good! The line drive over the crossbar, and the Hawks win! You want to talk about joy, jubilation, relief? That's a look at it right there.
I tell you what, Bob, that they blew the ready for play. They snapped that thing within 1 second. Didn't give him a chance to think about it anymore, did he? And then he kicked the ball so low, I thought it might hit the crossbar. Had plenty of leg to get, though. Wow. I guess you know your kicker, you know your kicker. And he felt comfortable at that distance. And Connor Bjornsson is a hero. He is the hero. And he can be a goat. The right kind of goat this time.
That's right.
What a game.
That that was something. I mean, you know, you get so used to when you watch pro and college football, you're used to seeing that kick, and it's that high arcing kick that you're waiting to go through. I got to tell you, it came off his foot, and I was like, I can't believe that's already through.
Between the snap and the kick, I said, don't blink, you missed it.
Exactly.
What a kick. I mean, it was true, though. It was absolutely true.
Yes.
There was no doubt about it. It was absolutely right through the wickets and in. What a win. And, again, kudos to the offense.
Hey, let's watch this from this angle.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting. I mean, it is snap, hold, great hold, bang. Oh, man. That's just not how they drop the field goals normally.
There's no style points.
He gets no elevation.
No elevation at all, yeah.
It's not about the style points. It's about the 3 points
absolutely
that win the game.
Yeah.
That's all that matters.
Oh,
look at him, so calm with it, and he lets it go. And look, he knows. He just walks away.
Yeah, he's already hands up. He knows I got it.
Yeah.
Again, it was all about the contact. Did he get enough of it? And he got plenty of it. Just, you know.
So there it is. That's how it ends. Oh. And what a game this was. You know?
Yeah.
You know, last year, 7-2, big defensive battle. Mm-hmm. This one was defensive as well. This game, like,
at every opportune time on both sides, there would be a big mistake that would take you out of having a great offense.
Yeah, and here, you know, kudos to the sales. What a performance they put on. You come off a 38-7 loss.
I'll tell you this. There are teams are going to watch this film.
Oh, yeah.
And they're going to learn a lot about this Hartley offense. The Hartley offense is going to have to adjust by the way that the sales played defense against them tonight.
The way they played 9-10 in the box and really just surrounded the ball. Yeah, Hartley's going to have to be aware of that. Teams are going to use that game plan. But, yeah, for DeSales, just too many missed opportunities when it came to getting their offense moving, only getting 6 points from their offense and 95 yards on one play. But their defense played great, really slowing down the Hartley offense, except when it mattered. That final drive, you saw the grinding running from Robert Lathan, 5-yard chunks, 6-yard, 10-yard chunks. Gullich, really nice passing on the short pass game, and then doing everything they needed to do to get in field goal range. One more center exchange fumble to make it a little dicey, but Connor Bjornsson comes through at the end. But that's the kind of game you want to play before the playoffs too, right? Because you're going to have those tight games in the playoffs, and you find a way to win them. Oh, what a play, what a play.
Yep, and again, now what DeSales will not like is that 15-yard penalty on that Fidel Somoza catch. As Gullich, right here it is. Face mask gets called on this play. You see some contact, and then the tackle is finished. It was a late flag thrown by an official downfield toward the end zone, and that tacked on 15 yards. And I mean, that was huge. But penalties were also a part of this game tonight. How many times did Hartley false start or jump, do something that would back him up? That go from first and 10 to first and 15.
Yeah, and and that penalty changed the way that possession went, but it didn't ultimately decide the game by any means. Because frankly, the next play call might be different if they're at the 30 instead of the 15. And I mean, let's be honest, Hartley gave 10 of those yards back on the fumble anyway.
Well, that's true. And further to your point, it took them out of running that shotgun passing offense, going back to the running offense when they got up.
Yeah, because you shorten the field, that it gets it that much tougher to make the pass, make that passing offense go like that. So, a tight game all in all. Again, kudos to both teams, because this was one of those CCO classics because of how good these teams are, how intense this rivalry is. No matter what their records are, I mean, DeSales falls to 3-5, but that's a good 3-5 team right there. Mm-hmm. That defense especially is really, really good. I'm looking forward to see them take on Waterston in 2 weeks. And then, boy, if you're Hartley, 6-2, riding all that momentum into a couple more home games, I'm feeling good about myself.
Yes, absolutely. Brad Birchfield, the head coach of the Hawks, addressing his team after their big win tonight. It went down to the final second. It went down to 0.8 seconds, as a matter of fact.
Which, by the way, I was waiting for that timeout to be caught. Like, hello?
Yeah.
0.8 is a little dicey for me.
And again, the funny part, and I said this during the play, like the players on the line were looking at the sideline and jumping up and down. Hey, we want to run another play. Mm-hmm. And Birchfield, very calm, he said, no, we're going to get it down to 1 second, call the timeout, we're kicking this field goal.
Yeah, and I think part of that, too, and this is where savvy coaching, you just saw your team fumble the ball and lose 10 yards. You call timeout third down. What happens if that happens again? And now you're out of field goal range and you're doing a Hail Mary. So I think he's like, let's cut our losses here.
No more plays.
We're done. I know
if we're snapping again, we're doing it in overtime.
Yes, I know my kicker can make it from right here. We're stopping. Know your limits. It's like when you're at the blackjack table. Know your limits. All right?
Right.
Get out.
And most people don't walk away.
No, they don't.
Brad Birchfield walked away. His team wins tonight. But as you said, it's an instant classic between these two teams here this evening. So well played on both sides. Again, both teams going to learn a lot from this. As you said, when you get to the playoffs, these are the kind of games you are going to play. You want to be prepared.
Yeah, yeah, and they are. And then, again, got a good couple home games here to get right here. Kip Columbus, good competition there. St. Charles, your final CCL matchup. And then, away we go in the one-and-dones. But, yeah, you feel good after losing to Waterston. You want to get that first CCL victory. You got it in tough fashion here at home. And, that was fun.
That was fun. Bob. I'm glad you were here tonight. I had a good time there. That was. All right, next week when Hartley takes on Kip, you will be able to watch that game live right here on Yamo Media. 7 o'clock game next week. Speaking of that, I'd like to thank everybody who's out there on the cameras tonight and doing the producing and running around and doing all the hard stuff Matt and I don't want to do.
So true.
Right? All right. Thanks for great work to our crew here tonight, and great work by both Hartley and DeSales, but it's the home team, the Hartley Hawks, that come through with the last-second field goal and win this game by the final score of 15-12. For Matt Barnes, I'm Bob McElligan saying good night from Jack Ryan Field here at Bishop Hartley. You've been watching Hartley Hawks football on Yamo Media.